you lost another one.
Y'all, hey, welcome everyone to Saki Speakeasy Podcast. I'm your host, Saki Speaks. Thanks for giving me a slice of your most precious commodity, your time. I truly appreciate you. Y'all, please do me a favor, and whenever she shows up, because y'all know she got that big promotion, so she working hard, show my moderator, Love Jones, a little love and affection, please, and thank you. And also, make sure to like the video on your way in the door, drop down in the chat box and say, hey, girl, hey. And if you haven't already, please consider subscribing to the channel, making sure that you click that notification bell and select all so you don't miss out on a single chapter. Now, with that being said, welcome to all of my brand new sippers and speakers. I appreciate each and every one of you for subscribing, and I hope that you each find a reason to stick around. And welcome back to all of my wonderful, crazy returning sippers and speakers, as well as those of you catching this on the replay. Thanks for coming back one more time to love up on your girl. Child, I'm trying to figure out if I'm going OD on the way that y'all love on me. All right. Thank you, everybody, for being here. Child, listen. I know y'all was like, now, I know she lying. She ain't coming out here today. Child, your girl been jacked up. I barely can see now, but I'm going to keep on keeping on because it's just one eye, child. So, My left eye, y'all, I don't know what it is, but there is something rolling around in that hole, and I have been washing this thing out. Oh, I don't know what it is. Whatever it is, it's got to be, I don't know what it is. You know, I called my doctor. She was like, girl, it could be anything from a very small eyelash to, you know, maybe a skin cell off of your finger, like if you were rubbing your eye or whatever. I don't know what the fuck it is, but whatever it is, it's got a bitch vexed over here. So I was like, I don't think I'm gonna be able to really see or nothing, you know, like what the hell. So it's hard to try to see out of one eye. I've been yawning all day, hoping that if I send enough water through this bastard, whatever it is, come on out, child. I don't know. But I didn't get any soap in my eye or anything this morning, you know, during my skincare routine. So I'm trying to figure out what in the fuck is stuck in my damn eye. But child, whatever it is, I ain't gonna worry about it. I'm alive, so that's good. But anyway, child, my left eye is jacked up. It's blurry as shit. And, yeah, we just gonna leave it right there. So I'm gonna try to get y'all a cute little skippity-pap right quick. Ah, shit, I was laughing when I first came in because my son talking about, have a good show, one eye. I'm like, nigga, you you ain't have to do that shit. Anyway, but whatever. All right, let me see who's here, child, so we can... see who here so we can get on down with the show. Hey, Kim Cash, first sipper and speaker through the door. Welcome, darling. Thank you for being here, lovey. I appreciate you. Marva was right behind you. Welcome, darling. I appreciate you being here. Wifey Pooh is in the building. Crazy tail self. This child ain't got no good goddamn sense. But hey, girl, hey. Irk and Jerk in the building, making sure we all be litty up in the city. Thank you for being here, darling. I appreciate you. L Boogie in the building. Child, L Boogie, welcome, darling. Don't you start no shit tonight. Thank you for being here, lovey. I appreciate you. Hey, Nora, welcome, welcome. Look who done made it in. Yaya is here. Child, I be seeing you commenting all over my doggone replay section. I'm glad you finally made it in here, but you still behind, boo, if you didn't catch the one from yesterday and shit, the one from before that. So you got to catch up a little bit more, baby, just a little bit more. Yeah, I got you earlier, Kim. Hey, Kayla, welcome, darling. Thank you for being here, lovey. I appreciate you. And you too, Summer, welcome. She's telling me I done caught up now. I'm all caught up. All right. Well, thank you for being here. I appreciate you. Hey, Dior, welcome, welcome. And hello, Janelle Marie, welcome. Thank you for being here. All right, I'm scrolling. Hey, Tracy, welcome, welcome. Thank you for being here, lovey. I appreciate you. Hey, Cupcake. Thank you for being here. Did I get everybody? Nope. Seti said is in the building. All right, y'all. I got everybody. All right. So let me see. I'm going to get this first time stamp, child. I was so tickled. I was trying to do the time stamps earlier today. And I was like, let's put this warning in here and let these folks know that it's about 40 minutes worth of fucking jibber jabbering before they get to the damn last chapter that I read yesterday, which was chapter 11. Because I'm telling you, y'all had me jacked up yesterday. But I'm going to let y'all slide because it's cool. It's very, very cool. All right. So here we go. Let's get started. Y'all bless my little one eye, child. Here we go. Chapter 12, Amos. The smell of him hit me right in the face as soon as I opened the door. When I flipped the light on, crime was still in the same spot I'd left him in a couple of days ago, bound and gagged with that fucking dildo. When I was gone, Duke had been keeping him drugged up every few hours. He looked terrible, and it wouldn't be long before he keeled over. When he looked at me, I waved my gloved hand in front of my face. This shit doesn't feel good, do it? I set my bag on the table. I opened it and pulled out the liquid adrenaline syringe that Dr. Wallace gave me. If I had the time, I'd keep your ass locked up for every day that you had Christina locked up. I pulled my knife and knife sharpener out and set them on the table. While I sharpened the knife, he started shaking the chains as much as he could while mumbling, "Oh, don't worry. I'll let you get some last words." When I felt the knife was sharpened good enough, I walked over and stood in front of him. Pause. Let me tell you one goddamn thing. I would be trying to swallow my tongue or something and choke myself out before I stand there and watch a dude sharpen a knife in front of me, knowing he gonna kill me. No, God. That's the ultimate torture. You're sitting there waiting to be sliced and diced, julienned, if you will. Child, you got me fucked up. All right. Don't feel good. Do it. Using the tip of my knife, I plucked the mask off his face before jabbing the tip of it into the balls and yanking it out of his mouth. You really jumped on my girl and tried to carve my initial out of her, huh? No, he stuttered. Don't fucking lie to me. He had several tattoos across his chest, arms, and back. I tapped the tip of the knife on a few of them. Eeny, meeny, miny, moe. Catch a nigga by his... I jabbed the tip of the knife about 2 inches in his chest, making him yell out in pain. You got any last words? Fuck you, nigga. If he hollers, let him. I pushed the knife 1 more inch down, an inch from his heart. You son of a bitch, he hissed out. When I pulled the knife out, blood spilled out down his chest. He screamed out in agony, making me smile. That sounds like music to my ears. Scream louder. The louder you scream, the faster you'll die, if that helps. Otherwise, you got about 30 minutes before you bleed out. On his back was a medium-sized tattoo of Christina's name. You don't deserve to wear this motherfucking name, nigga. I jabbed the knife into his back, not caring how deep, and started tracing Christina's name out of him. The way he was screaming let me know that he was about to pass out. The minute he passed out, I pulled the syringe from my pocket and jabbed it into that wound that I'd made on his chest and pushed the liquid inside of him. Just a few seconds later, a sharp inhale came from him. Oh, no, nigga. You don't get to go that easy. Just kill me. I am. I carved deeper and deeper as I went around her name while he yelled out in agony. Yeah, apologize to my girl. Apologize to my motherfucking girl. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry, he yelled out. I toggled that plug of skin out of his back, dodging a stream of blood that squirted out. He was getting weaker and weaker. Walking around in front of him, I stared at him in disgust. He continued to yell out in pain, annoying me, so I stuffed his own flesh in his mouth. Shut up, bitch nigga. When I closed my eyes, I pictured my baby crying out for me as she laid under him, stabbing him. Rearing back, I punched him in his face as hard as I could. When I blinked again, I saw the bruises on her face and body, and I punched him again. And then I punched him again and again and again. I kept punching him for all the frustrations that he caused me over the last couple of months. I didn't stop until I felt my phone vibrating in my pocket. I stepped away from his dead body, trying to catch my breath. After taking a few minutes to catch my breath, I started cleaning up the room. And there's a break in the chapter. Child, listen. Whew, that was a lot, even for my good eye. Whew, Lord. Hey, Simply Dorian, welcome. Thank you for being here, darling. I appreciate you. Oh, my God, child. Listen. All right, let me get back at it. Child, this thing be so crazy. All right. Hours later, I'd taken care of Crime's body, gotten that room cleaned up, and was headed back to Duke's house to get me some breakfast and also to check the temperature regarding Mom. Thanksgiving was tomorrow, and she told me last night before I left that she hadn't been able to talk to Duke. She claimed she hadn't been able to talk to Duke, but she'd managed to have late nights and early mornings with my father. That wasn't anything but a recipe for disaster, and I just knew that it was going to blow up at the most important time. Wait. Child, the words is on 2 different pages, so it's actually inopportune time. Cross-eyed ass. All right. Like I've been over here smoking weed rolled in backwards or something. No, God, a bitch can't see. All right. When I was halfway to Duke's house, I called Healing Souls so I could leave Christina a message. I'd been leaving them every morning, noon, and evening. I made sure to catch them right after a shift change so I could make sure that she got the message so they wouldn't get tossed to the side by some motherfucker that was ready to go home. Everybody's background check came back straight. They picked up after a few rings. Healing Souls, how may I direct your call? Amos Duke, I'd like to leave a message for Christina Chase. Hi, Mr. Duke. She spoke low into the phone like they'd been doing every time I called. Hello, can I leave a message with Christina Chase? Oh, yes, yes, wait. I kissed my teeth. Ember would like to speak to you. Can I send you over to her? Yeah, the whole music sounded like elevator music. Amos, how are you this morning? Could be better if I could leave a message for... About that, Christina needs to stay focused. Messages telling her that you can't wait to lay up with her are not conducive to her recovery. I don't want her counting down the days until she gets out of here. I'm not telling you that you can't leave messages. I'm asking if you can limit the messages to I love you or I'm proud of you and stuff like that. You do understand, right? You don't believe she can focus by me telling her that I can't wait to cuddle with her? No attitude. I genuinely want to know because I want to help as much as I can. No, Christina is already... Hold on. Sounds of her rifling through papers were loud in the phone. I had to make sure you were on her list of people that I could give updates to. She already doesn't want to be here. Sending messages like that only makes her want to leave even more. It could be read as you encouraging her to leave. If I did accept messages like that, it would say something along the lines of, Christina, when you finish your program, we're gonna cuddle a lot. Something like that. You have to encourage her to finish. Damn, I guess you're right. I never thought about it like that. What else been going on since you can give me updates? She's like peeling a potato with my fingers, but I got strong fingernails and I'm up for the task. Sounds like her. Ember chuckled lightly. So, what do you want your message to say? I love you. Keep fighting. You a warrior. And daddy can't. Amos? Damn, I can't say daddy either. You're not her father, so I scoffed. All right, man, just tell her that. I will. Have a good day, she said, and ended the call. I'd be like, hey, yo, bitch, I'm coming to get my girl. I'll pay somebody to get her rehab at the fucking crib. What do you mean I can't say when you get out, we gonna cuddle the fuck up? Like, I need to give the bitch something to look forward to, damn. Anyway, I hated that I couldn't leave the type of messages I wanted to, but at least it seemed like they really cared about her over there. Helen and I had a lengthy conversation after I dropped her off. She seemed nice, but those were the type of people that would surprise you. So I made sure to get a deeper background check on her. I never thought that I'd miss someone as bad as I did and couldn't see them whenever I wanted. Last night, the pictures and videos weren't doing it for me, so I had to see her. I knew the lady at the front desk wasn't going to let me see her, which was probably better for her, but I had to. I'd gotten my custom-made drone a few years back as a gift from Duke. That drone could go 40 miles, so I drove closer to the place and sent my drone to her. I could see that she was up because a light was on. When she ducked out of the way like she was ducking from a real bullet, I nearly made the drone drop from laughing. Wait, pause, because y'all remember when she saw the red light and then she was ducking, right? I was like, this fucking girl think it's a beam. I'm like, it's... she thinking somebody outside to up the stick on her ass. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Only to see that it was a fucking drone because her nigga trying to see her. Oh, my God. All right, let me... Oh, my God, that is crazy as shit. All right. She was such a character. I pulled around the driveway and parked behind Irvy's car. As soon as I walked in the house, I got a whiff of Steven's French toast. Rounding the corner to the dining room, I stopped in my tracks when I saw my brother had Irvy on her back on the dining room table with his head buried in her neck. I just wanted breakfast, I said, interrupting them and turning around. Irvy gasped before scurrying out of the room. Could you announce yourself when you walk in here? He snapped. I turned around and looked at him. I ain't never announced myself, and I ain't about to start. Deal with it. He rested his fists on his waist and sighed. What do you want, Amos? If this can wait, please let it wait. He started for the stairs. That situation is taken care of. He stopped and turned around. About damn time, I thought I was going to have to take care of that for you. Is that all you want? God damn, I just want some breakfast. Are you trying to put me out of something? Yes, he stressed. AD is cutting a tooth, and boy, it's been a rough few nights. I'm not gonna lie, and between that and your girl, my dick is about to... You finish that sentence, and I'll make sure your dick does whatever you were about to say. Irvy said, walking into the dining room holding AD. Good morning, Amos. How long will you be staying? She asked while putting the baby in my arms. We'll be 10 minutes, Irvy said, while grabbing Duke by his wrist into the hallway. Shitting me, he responded. I just wanted breakfast, I mumbled. When I looked down at him, he was staring up at me. He was chewing on a frozen chewy toy. I moved it away from his mouth so I could see his little tooth. Oh, I see a little something-something, I said, moving his lip a little, making him smile. Well, you at the right age, I guess. You know, some babies already be born with teeth. Pause, sir. Why the fuck are you telling the baby that? what the baby's supposed to say? Oh, okay, well, I guess I should feel better then, my nigga. The fuck? Anyway, I looked up at Stephen as he entered the room. Amos, good morning. You want breakfast? Yes, thank you. When he sounded like he was getting fussy, I started to bounce my leg. Looking down at him, I wondered how my genes would have showed up in my child because Chris looked just like her dad, too. I think we'd have a pretty little girl with deep dimples like her mother and her attitude. Sir, or it could come out with your face. Like, what the hell? Anyway, I couldn't deal with a girl with my attitude, and neither could anybody else, good sir. She needed to have one or the other because both of our attitudes mixed up would have me and Christina homeschooling her. Man, I wish she wouldn't have lost our child, but honestly, I felt that was probably for the best. She needed to focus on herself. Here you go. Stephen sat a tray of food and drinks in front of me and walked away. I was starving. You don't know how lucky you are, AD. You got the best mom and dad. If something happens to them, which it won't because I'll always have their back, I'd have to take care of you. Wouldn't that be something? I can't wait to give you some cousins. He was going to town on that teething ring. An hour later, Duke made his way back downstairs looking like a man that won the lottery. He been crying? He asked, taking him out of my arms. Nah, we been chilling. He raised his eyebrow. You straight, bro? Yeah, why? He sat in the seat across from me. You looked spaced out. Nah, I'm good. Okay. Irvy invited Christina's parents to Thanksgiving dinner tomorrow. Did Irvy forget that that woman no longer likes me? Well, apparently she accepted the invite, so she must be okay with you now. You got an update on Chris? She's being her. You know how that goes. Have you? No, I have not and don't plan on it. Your father told me that she was going to be there tomorrow against my wishes, so I don't know how that's going to go. Against your wishes? Just tell Dad what happened and I'm sure he'd blow a gasket and send her away or even break her neck. He didn't say anything. He started teasing AD with his teething ring. Unless you don't want him to. He looked at me. What does that mean? I shrugged my shoulders. It means what it means. We stared at each other before he sat back in his seat. Duke, let's be real with each other. You've known where she was for a while. You could have killed her, and we would have never known any different, but you let her live. Why? You know, I was thinking about that. You shouldn't be. Don't look into it any deeper than that, because it's not that deep. But I think it is, though. He ignored me. You never wanted to kill her. You wanted to make her suffer. Amos? What? I don't think I'm lying. What is it that you want from her, then? I don't want shit from her. Yes, you do. You've had 15 years to kill her, but you didn't. You wanted her to suffer, and she has. You know that she loves us, and keeping her away from us is hurting her. I'm saying this, but I don't want to downplay what she did to you. That's why I'm asking you what the real deal is. He shrugged his shoulders and raised his eyebrows in response to what I said. I wouldn't put it past Duke to just want her to suffer. And people thought I was ruthless, but my brother was worse than me. Pause. That was the best kind of suffering, like, if that makes sense. Because she had to move around always, you know, with her fucking eyes looking in the back of her head because she didn't know when the fuck he was going to show up. And she always knew where the fuck he was because he's his daddy's son. So, yeah, that's worse. That's worse than just, you know, killing her and putting her out of her misery. So, yeah. Duke is a torturous motherfucker. I don't know what it is about niggas. Anyway, Irvy broke our staring contest when she made her way back into the dining room. Amos, I hope Duke told you that I invited Mama Laura and Chris for Thanksgiving. I nodded my head. I'm hoping that this will be a chance for you all to talk or something and try to get to know each other outside of Chris. I hope she don't be mad at me for that. I don't know. She tried to attack me. I don't know how that's going to go, but I'm open. Since you're trying to make connections, Amos, don't start that bullshit. I held my hands up in surrender. Oh, that's not happening. I told him that he should do whatever he wants to do, but figure it out soon, because y'all ain't about to sit here and talk about me like I'm not sitting here. She looked down at him and then back at me. Anyway, he has a right to not deal with her because of how she treated him, but I told him that he's not going to have to figure out how he's going to deal with the situation because he and your mom are looking really comfy these days. I'll handle that whenever I need to handle that. Is that okay with y'all? Let me just stay out of your... That'll be greatly appreciated. Damn! You ain't even let him finish his sentence. I shook my head while pushing back from the table. Tomorrow was going to be a fucking shit show if I ever saw one. And there's a break in the chapter. Child, listen. Okay, so he didn't want to kill the woman. What is the fucking problem with her coming to their father's house then, since you didn't kill her? Make that make sense. Anyway, because it was a little break in the chapter. When I made it home, my dad's car was in front of my house. I prayed that they weren't in my house fucking or I would have lost my damn mind. In the house, I heard the piano coming from down the hall and I smelled my dad's cigar smoke. How you gonna just light your fucking cigar in my house, sir? No God. Anyway, when I walked in the room, my mother sat at the piano while my father sat on the couch with a cigar between his lips. She stopped playing when she noticed me. Her face was healing from when Angel attacked her. Amos, good morning, my mother spoke. Son, you okay? Yeah, why you ask? You've been having a rough few weeks. Just wanted to check on you and see how you were doing. That's it. Ah, well, I'm good. You know I'm not gonna complain. Good. Look around. You can never complain. Come sit and listen to your mother sing. I fell in love with her voice the first time I heard it. When I looked at her, she had a smirk on her face. I went and sat on the couch with my father. Where did you hear it? Do y'all know y'all never told us how y'all met for real? I remembered what my mother told me, but I wanted to know if their stories matched up. He laughed before sitting back and puffing on his cigar. Well, it all started when I went to church. I immediately looked taken aback, making him chuckle. Yeah, I know. I shouldn't have been nowhere near a church, but your grandfather said that's where I needed to find a wife. Stop with the looks. Times were different then. We didn't have phones that we could swipe right or left on. We actually had to go out and meet people. Well, I was in church getting ready to leave because the women that were trying to talk to me were not women that I would have ever laid down with, yet alone or produce children. It was like they were saving your mother for last, like a big joker or something. As I was leaving, I heard her voice, making me stop in my tracks. When I turned around and laid eyes on her, I knew that she was the one. I think it was Amazing Grace she was singing. Sang so good, I put $500 in the offering. You know how much $500 was back then? It was a lot, sir. I understand. Anyway, Mom rolled her eyes and tightened her lips. After the service was over, all the men were in her face trying to get her number. I had to stand out, and I did when I saw her with her parents. Introducing myself... No, he said, introduced myself, sorry. Introduced myself and asked if I could take her out on a date, and the rest was history. I was married and pregnant with LD before I knew it. That's right. She was the perfect woman for me. They were making googly eyes at each other. Amos, come and sing with me. I didn't miss the look on my dad's face out of the corner of my eye. I hated that your father wouldn't. Don't start, Cat. I wanted to hear your voice. Not wanting to get in that, I stood up. Well, I'll leave you two to it. As I walked out of the room, I heard my mother mumble something about how he still hadn't changed. My dad let her know that the conversation was over by telling her to keep singing. Oh, shit. And there's another break and 11 minutes left in the chapter. All right. The next afternoon, Thanksgiving. I just pulled up to my dad's house for Thanksgiving dinner. Every year, we rotated who would host. Last year, it was Angel's house. This year, it was my dad's. And next year, it would be my turn. God willing, Chris and I would be great hosts. Judging by the cars that were in the yard, everyone was already here. Duke, Irvy, and her family. Stephen and his family. Christina's family. Dr. Wallace's car was in the yard. My mom came and stayed over here last night. From the looks of it, everyone was waiting on me. even though we still had at least 2 hours before we ate, usually the women were sitting around gossiping, snacking, and drinking while the men watched sports all day until the food was ready. We'd all eat together before everyone found something to do. The weather was straight, so at least at some point, we'd all gravitate to the deck. As soon as I stepped through the door, the smell of Thanksgiving hit me right in the face. My stomach instantly started growling. "Good afternoon, Amos. Everyone is out back," the butler said. "All right, thank you." When my phone buzzed in my pocket, I knew that it was time for me to call and leave Chris a message. Ember texted me this morning to let me know that she'd been having a bad morning. She didn't get out of bed and hadn't gone to breakfast or any of her therapy. That worried me a little because I didn't want her to regress. Ember reassured me that she was just going through the motions and sad, which was what happened to a lot of addicts in rehab around the holidays. She was the expert, so I believed her, but it didn't stop me from worrying about Chris. "Why you ain't going over her room with the fucking drone then, sir? You got the goddamn equipment, use it." I walked upstairs and ducked off in one of the empty rooms so I could call. I put the phone to my ear while the phone rang. "Healing Souls, can I put you on hold for just a moment?" Before I could respond, I'd heard the elevator music. I looked up as a pair of shadows went by. I stepped closer to the door and stopped when I heard my dad's voice. "Dorinda, what the hell is wrong with you? You are blatantly ignoring me in my own fucking house," my dad whisper shouted. "Ha, AD, I have been so patient with you, and I am tired. I have put my life on hold for decades waiting for you to see what the hell you had in front of your eyes." That was Dr. Wallace. Luckily, I didn't close the door all the way, and through the crack in the door, I saw them standing across the hall. Dr. Wallace had her arms folded across her chest, dabbing at tears with the back of her free hand. My dad's hands were resting in his pockets. His jaw muscles were clenching. Her back was to me, but I could see my father's face. Do not fix your lips to tell me that you do not understand. I've been working for you for over half of my life. I didn't come into this expecting to fall in love with you, AD, but I did. We were only having fun, and you made me fall in love with you, and you can't possibly think that you were in this alone, D. But I am in this alone. From the looks of it, I'll always be in this alone. For 16 years, it was me. I took care of you, your company, the children, who I love as if they are my own. They are mine, honestly. And you let her waltz in here and pick back up like you guys are still in the honeymoon phase, never giving me or us a shot. Every time I tried to move on from this toxic situation, you yanked me back in, never giving a damn about my feelings as long as you had me. Healing Souls, how may I help you? The woman said into my ear, but I ignored her. There was Chuck. You beat him to a pulp. And then James, you choked him until he couldn't breathe. Larry, I can't remember if that was the brake line cut or what, but I hope you see where I'm going with this. I've tried to be happy without you, but you won't let me, and I can't understand why you do this to me, AD. D, what do you want me to do? She is my wife. That's all I've heard, been hearing. I won't hear it anymore. I won't do this back and forth anymore. I'm not going to sit around and watch you drool all over her until she leaves again. I am in my 50s, and I can still have a great life. This is my... D, please, don't. How can I fix this? I'm begging. I'll get on my knees and beg you. Please. Healing Souls, how may I help you? A lump formed in my throat. I'd never seen my father so vulnerable. She shook her head. There is nothing else you can do. I won't watch you love her like she's perfect, and she's not. I held my breath, hoping that Dr. Wallace wouldn't break the news to my father about what she did to Duke. D, I love you. I am in love with you, deeply. You think I hurt all those men just because? You are one selfish man, AD, and you know that. If you could have both of us in that bed together, you would. When my dad's eyes filled with water, so did mine. No lie, I couldn't believe what I was seeing. If you are hurt or can't talk, we can connect you with the ambulance or police. This is my resignation, Anais, effective immediately. No, Dorinda, I don't accept. Please, don't do this to me right now. Just give me time. Let me figure some things out. Just let me... He took his hands out of his pockets and grabbed the hand that she wiped her tears with. She used her free hand to wipe his tears away. I'd never seen my father cry, ever. even though my mother was downstairs, I still hurt for my father. Anais, as long as I've known you, no one has ever seen this side of you but me. That's how I know that you love me. I don't reject that. You just can't give me the love and companionship that I'm looking for now at this stage of my life. I hope that you have a nice life. Dee, I'll tell the kids in my own way and find them someone else I trust for the staff. She pulled away from him. I am going to hang up now. Please call back when you can talk. The three beeps let me know the phone call had ended, but I was completely frozen with my phone still to my ear. Who is it? Is it Henry? I'm not letting you harm another man in my life, A.D. She stood on her tiptoes and kissed his cheek. When she turned around, tears streamed down her face. I watched my father wipe his eyes before continuing down the hall. Getting closer to the door, I peeked to see that he'd opened the door to his bedroom and slammed the door as hard as he could. I'm sure that the people outside heard it. After a few moments, I was finally able to move. I slipped my phone into my pocket and walked out of the room. As I walked down the stairs, my mind drifted to every time I saw them together, the way they smiled at each other, my dad always having to touch her, the way he looked at her when she'd be on the phone laughing. At one time, she brought someone to a family dinner and never seeing the man again. The medical conferences around the same time as my dad having to work out of town. That one time, she brought another man to an event and my dad being salty all night. Everything started coming together and I chuckled to myself at how I'd miss what was right in front of me the whole time. Outside, looking around the deck, I saw Dr. Wallace in the corner talking to Angel. Angel was covering her mouth with her hand with wide eyes on her face. My mother sat in a corner with Stephen's wife. Irvy, her mother, and her sister were sitting at the bar having a drink. I'd found Duke, Miko, and Chris. Miko was lifting his grandson in the air, making him laugh. About time, I thought I was going to have to send someone after you. When he noticed the blank look on my face, he squinted and nodded his head toward the house. Excuse me, gentlemen. Following him in the house, we found a quiet place where no one could hear us talk. He turned around and faced me. Okay, what's going on? You been crying? Eyes red as hell. You gotta tell the dad, not tell the dad the truth. You gotta tell dad the truth, but it says the dad. I bullshit you not, I promise you. It says you gotta tell the dad. Anyway, gotta tell dad the truth, Duke. About? Y'all, what the fuck? Angel appeared at our sides. You could tell that she'd been crying. The rims of her eyes were swollen and the whites of her eyes were bloodshot. Okay, what the fuck is going on? Dr. Wallace quit, and she's leaving us completely. Duke cocked his head to the side. Excuse me, when did this happen? I looked at the floor. Just a few minutes ago, I heard it. I was in the room, and they were upstairs talking. He made a small circle with his hand, telling me to speed the story up. She's breaking up with him. Shit. Duke clasped his hands together on top of his head. He cried. They both whipped their heads toward me. I couldn't believe it. He cried. No, I don't believe that, Duke said while shaking his head. I could literally see his heart fucking breaking. That shit hurt me. I'd never seen that in all my life. Even when Mom left the first time, you have to tell Dad the truth, Duke. Dad appeared in the doorway. If I hadn't seen it for myself, he would have never known that he'd just gotten finished crying. Tell me the truth about what, he said. No one said anything, but me and Angel looked at Duke. Pulling my vibrating phone out of my pocket, I saw that it was a message from Ember. And the message reads, there is an emergency here at HS. Can you come? It's urgent. I stared at my phone because I didn't know if I could get any more bad news today. What's going on? Duke asked. I gotta go check on Christina. Save me a plate if I'm not back. Don't tell Irvy just yet. All right, keep me updated.
Damn, I need to know what the fuck to tell your daddy. Fuck the girl. She'll be all right. She at the Heal and Souls place. Shit. Pissing me off. Got my heart palpitating. Shit.
I walked by my father and out of the room. I heard him asking Duke what I was talking about, and he responded saying, another time, making me shake my head. My mind went to Christina, hoping that everything was good, but I could read the urgency in Ember's text. As soon as I was in the car, I called her. Amos. Hi, are you coming? Yeah, I'm in the car now. What's going on? Christina is asking to leave. What? Why? She didn't say anything. Her voice trembled. She cleared her throat. Sorry, I just get so invested in my clients. That is very unprofessional of me. Indeed it is, bitch. Knock it the fuck off. And today is just a very bad day for her, and she's lashed out at several of the workers, including me, and now she's locked herself in the room and broken a mirror. Fuck, man. Did you call the ambulance? She could be bleeding out in the fucking room. I did not call the ambulance because I asked her if she was okay, and she said she wasn't suicidal, and I believe her. If I call the ambulance, I'll have to have her committed involuntarily, which is an automatic 3-day hold, several evaluations, and total isolation, cuffed to a bed. If that happens to her at this stage in her sobriety, we will lose her for good, Amos. I can't let that happen. I slammed my fist against the steering wheel. I'm taking her home. No, she shouted. You can't. No. Fuck you mean no. You just fucking told me that my girl just broke a fucking mirror and... Amos, she needs real help, and I have so much faith in her. I can get through to her. I know I can. Just give me a chance, and please, calm down. Pause. First of all, bitch, friend or not, you should not have told him any of this until you were in front of him. That's first. But I guess that's why she said, this is so unprofessional. Because it fucking is. This is that boogie down bullshit I be talking about that make us look bad. Damn. Anyway, this is in a book. Fuck that. All right. You can't get through to her, ma'am, because if you could, you would have already. Damn. Okay. All right. I sighed. So why are you calling me telling me it's urgent and I can't take my girl home? I'm not telling you that you can't, but I'm advising against it. Listen, I'm calling you because she has you down as her next of kin. You can get through to her, telling her that if she works the program, everything will work out the way it's supposed to. If she knows that you'll come rescue her every time she gets into trouble, she won't really have an incentive to change. As an addict, she'll prey on that every time. Now, that part is true. I also would like to extend her stay. I looked at the phone like she could see me. Extend her stay? Why? And you want me to be the bad guy? I told her that if she went to rehab, she'd get out before Christmas. She can still get out before Christmas. Her original leave date was the beginning of the third week of December, if I remember correctly. Let me keep her until Christmas Eve. I'll see what I can do, but no guarantees. You can do it. Girl, wait, what? Bitch, no. Fuck no and hell no. That's fucking wrong of her to do that. I'm about 45 minutes out. I'll be there, I said before ending the call. Women were put on the fucking earth just to stress men out because ever since I fell in fucking love, Christina ain't done shit but stress me the fuck out. And that's the end of that chapter. Listen, I am so goddamn annoyed right now. Like, this lady, that is fucked up. You don't do that, ma'am. You don't do that. Oh, fucking trash. Anyway, hey, Kia B, welcome, darling. Thank you for being here, lovey. I appreciate you. Buck, who likes to fuck? Welcome, welcome. Thank you for being here, darling. I appreciate you. Let me see. Who else? Hey, M. Royce, welcome, welcome. Hey, Buns, welcome. Hey, Peanut, welcome, darling. Thank you for being here, lovey. I appreciate you. I'm still going. Did I miss anybody else? Child, my fucking eye has got me just, ugh. All right, let me close the bad eye because I'm trying to strain through the good eye. Hey, Kaylin, welcome, boo. Thank you for being here, lovey. I appreciate you. Wait, what'd she say? I was in tears because it ain't click with me at first on what the fuck he meant to. Oh, okay, because I was like, what the fuck? I thought she was trying to say at to somebody. Buck, please tell me. You heard Saki last night about your lockdown water bags. Go to hell, Peanut. All right. I spoke to Kayla. Hey, church lady. I knew it was somebody else. Welcome, boo. Thank you for being here, lovey. Hey, Ebony. Welcome, welcome. All right. Let me see. Anybody else? See, this is the bullshit I be talking about right here. So I'm invested, aren't we, Sankey? Nope, not at all. Hey, Shakara, welcome, boo. Y'all might get a lot of shit past me today because I ain't got but one fucking eye working proper dopper. But I tell you what, tomorrow a bitch is going to be in full effect and y'all ain't going to be able to get away with shit. Fuck around and drop the wrong size period in the damn chat and I'm going to hog tie your ass. How about that? That's what we doing right there. All right, let me get this damn timestamp so we can boogie on down the road.
Hey, the fuck you tearing up there?
Excuse me, sorry.
Son, god damn it.
Get the fuck away from me, yo. I thought you was falling or something. Oh, Lord. All right, y'all. Shit. I thought you had fell down as loud as it was. I'm up here like, what the hell? All right, I'm sorry. Josh. He told me I'm all right. I'm just black. Listen, my son is a fucking a complete jokester, too. Lord have mercy. All right, let me get this damn time stamp again. That's it? I got a hole you dig up in my room, though. All right, this ain't working. All right, I got our time stamp. We just got to wait for it to count down. No, don't even go back and watch it. No, Buck, don't listen to her. She a troublemaker. She a troublemaker. Chapter 13, Christina. When I woke up this morning, I was on the wrong side of the bed for some odd reason. Hey, before you go, I need a little heat on my, your dig here. Sorry. Completely forgot about it. Maybe like a minute. Yeah, because that's a lot of coffee. Like a minute. Because it'd be cooling off when I'm reading. I need the, what you call it thing, with the top to keep the jive warm. All right, y'all, I'm sorry. I got to keep my throat bathed in warm liquids. That sounded really horrible, but I mean warm coffee and shit like that. Not just... All right. When I woke up this morning, I was on the wrong side of the bed for some odd reason. There wasn't a bad dream that woke me up crying or nothing like that. I didn't know what happened. I even tried to go back to sleep, wake up, and try again, but nothing could get me out of the bed. The first tech that came to my room got ignored. The second tech that came to my room got cursed out really bad, leaving with tears in her eyes. She asked for it, though, because I told her to leave me the fuck alone and just let me lay here until I felt better. After the second tech couldn't get me out of bed, they'd left me alone. I watched the clock as each minute passed, then each hour. I'd rolled over and stared at the ceiling. Christina, what is wrong, girl? Out of nowhere, my eyes filled with tears and my tears slipped down my face. This onset of depression just hit me out of nowhere. Nothing was on my mind. Nothing could compute. There were a few knocks on the door. Go away, I shouted out. The door opened and the sun nearly blinded me because I had the room dark. It's Ember. I'm coming in. I'm telling you now, I will curse you out. I know. She pulled the chair near my bed and sat down. Happy Thanksgiving, Christina. She opened the folder, pulled a sheet of paper out, and laid it on the bed. I didn't look at it, nor did I say anything.
Thank you.
Just the other day, you wrote down that you were thankful for life when I asked you to complete that assignment.
I was saying thank you.
You remember? How did you go from that to this moment you're experiencing? I didn't say anything. Are you angry about last night? We had a very intense therapy session yesterday. She was right. In our therapy session, we did somehow jump to my mother and father's relationship, and it didn't go how I expected it. I don't know why I got so upset at her telling me that I wasn't allowed to make decisions for my mother regarding her love life, regardless of how angry it made me. She said that I could have feelings because we're human, but I couldn't tell her who to date. She also told me that I hadn't even gotten my dad's side of the story. She even had the nerve to tell me that I wasn't being fair to either one of them. There was a lot more, but thinking about it was about to get me heated again. Didn't you participate in group just yesterday morning, telling them that you were deathly afraid of experiencing these emotions sober? Get out! Christina, I told you that it is okay to feel these things and not want to numb them. You also didn't tell me that every time I fucking opened up to you, you'd make everything my fault. Did I make everything your fault, or did I want you to take some accountability for some of your actions and responses to situations in your life? You're angry because I told you that you're an addict, and it was your brain telling you to use drugs as a response to situations that you deemed stressful to you. I turned away from her. Amber, I'm asking you nicely to get out. I'm going to get my shit and I am going to leave. I am sober and no longer need this place. I don't recommend that. You may be out of withdrawal, but you still don't have the skills to cope yet, Christina. I don't give a fuck about what you recommend, Amber. Get out and get my discharge papers ready. She scooted the chair back and stood up. The minute she left the room, I got up and put the chair under the door handle. I didn't want anyone else coming in the room until I was ready to get my things and leave. I stood in front of the mirror crying my eyes out. My chest grew tighter and tighter as I sobbed. The doctor said the arrhythmia would eventually work itself out once I got out of withdrawal. And if I didn't, I should come back. I hadn't had the extra flutter in my heart since I lost the baby. Picking up the hairdryer, I smashed it against the mirror, shattering it in some places. I heard the scream outside and someone trying to push the door in. Chris, talk to me, please. Are you okay? Yes, I do not want to kill myself. Go away. Instead of lying in bed, I laid on the floor, curling into the fetal position. I closed my eyes and rocked. Arizona. I didn't know how long I'd been laying on the floor until three hard knocks startled me. Go away, Christina. I sat up against the bed. I hadn't heard his voice since I'd been here, and I missed him so bad. It's Amos. Can you open the door for me? I crawled over to the sink and pulled myself up. In the shattered part, I could see that I was looking halfway decent. I had on a long t-shirt and my underwear. Chris. Walking across the room, I removed the chain from under the handle and opened the door. Why do they put chain? Okay. My breath caught in my throat. He was so handsome, even though he only had on a plain black sweater and a pair of black pants with his favorite Gucci shoes. He had a fresh haircut and the diamonds danced on the two chains around his neck. He smelled delicious. Can I come in? I nodded my head, moving out of the way. When he walked in, I closed the door behind him. I took a deep breath and turned around to see him staring at me. You in here acting up today? What's going on, baby? I shrugged my shoulders before I was overcome with emotions and ran into his chest. He wrapped his arms around me, squeezing me tightly. I started to sob. What's going on, baby? Talk to me. I shrugged my shoulders and shook my head. Come on, let's sit down. He sat me on the bed before grabbing the chair and pulling it in front of me. Talk to me. He sat in the chair and grabbed my hands. I looked at him. Ember called you, didn't she? He nodded his head. I told her that I was fine and that I'm ready to go. You're here to get me, right? He didn't respond. He looked past me and then back at me. You did that? It was my turn to stay silent. Come here. He grabbed my hand, pulling me to my feet. He walked me over to the mirror and stood behind me. The shattered lines were going through our faces, making us barely visible. Why did you do this? I shrugged my shoulders. Yes, you do. Close your eyes and tell me the first thing that comes to mind. It doesn't matter what it is. When I closed my eyes, I didn't see or think of anything. My mind is clear. He leaned against the wall and folded his arms across his chest. Your mind is clear. I nodded my head. Your mind being clear is the goal that we were striving for, rehab, right? I nodded my head before turning around and looking up at him. Yes, that was the goal. So now I can leave, right? You're here to take me home, our home. He stood straight up, looking me directly in my eyes. I'm not here to take you home. He paused. Ember recommended. Don't fucking tell me what she recommends. I want to go home. Christina, your mind may be clear, but you don't have the skills needed to cope on days like today. You can't go around breaking mirrors. You don't know how to respond to your mind being clear, and that is a problem. I shook my head. No. Yes, your time has been extended to Christmas Eve. My mouth nearly hit my chest. Tears filled my eyes. You can't do this to me. I thought you were on my side. I thought you loved me. I do, and you know that. That's why I'm agreeing that you should stay. Chris, you're not putting your all into this program, and that's not helping you. I ignored everything he said. If you love me, you'll check me out of here. Chris, don't do that. You know how I feel about you.
I nodded my head while I swatted at the tears that slipped down my face. When he reached for my face, I tried to dodge his hands, but he gripped my face and wiped my tears. Through cloudy eyes, I could see his eyes filling with water. I wouldn't be here if I didn't love you. I wouldn't be doing this if I didn't love you. The knocks on the door didn't drop our eye contact. Is everything okay? Ember asked. Yes, Amos replied. Chris is gonna stay the extended time. I shook my head slowly. I'll never speak to you again. Somehow, I don't believe that. Come on, Amos. It's time. He tried to kiss my forehead, but I dodged it. Get out, I hissed. Go. He backed away from me, but he wasn't going fast enough for me, so I pushed him. Get out! Get out! He wrapped his arms around me while I tried to push him away. I started screaming at the top of my lungs like a child. Amos, let's go, Ember commanded. I love you, Chris. Get out, both of you! I jumped into bed and covered my head before Ember closed the door. And there's a break in the chapter. Let me tell you something. Ooh, Lord, hamburger and crispy french fries. Mm-mm. Let me wet my whistle. Y'all don't even fucking understand. Nope. All right. Hours later, I was in the same spot as I was when Ember rushed Amos out of the room when I heard a few knocks on the door. It's me, Ember, she said when the door opened. My stomach started to growl the moment I got a whiff of the food. I have food. I know you're hungry. I didn't say anything. I can hear your stomach from over here. Sit up and get something to eat. You don't have to talk to me if you don't want to. Slowly, I removed the covers from my head and looked at her. In one hand was a brown bag and in the other was a drink holder with two drinks. Her lips were spread across her face like I hadn't cursed her out several times earlier. She set what I assumed was her food and drink on the table, then set my drink on my nightstand and handed a food container to me. I don't want to eat lunch with you, bitch, or dinner. Get the fuck out of my room. That's me talking, not her. Inside was a club sandwich and a mixture of onion rings and french fries. It looks good. Where did you get this? My wife is a chef and she fixed it for us. I told her one of my patients wasn't having a good day and your favorite foods. I hope this helps. My favorite foods? You must have talked to him. She nodded her head. He said he wanted to bring you some Thanksgiving food, but I didn't think that was a good idea. Good. I am done with him. Take him off the list. I am serious. Done. You're angry at me? At him? Him. Both of you. Him for not taking me when I asked him to, and you for making him tell me instead of telling me yourself. How am I supposed to trust you if you can't talk to me? She looked at her food and then at me. You trust me? She asked softly. I did. I wanted him to tell you because I didn't think you trusted me yet. I took the top off the container and bit into one of the onion rings. My taste buds danced in my mouth. I closed my eyes as if that would make me savor the taste. Either I am starving or these things are very delicious, she laughed. Probably both. I stuffed the other half of the onion into my mouth. Is Amos your boyfriend? When I closed my eyes, I immediately saw the moment that the person had brought out dessert with Amos, asking me if I wanted to be his girlfriend with yes and no boxes. I just realized that I'd never answered his question. What are you thinking about? He'd asked me, but I didn't get a chance to answer. My ex interrupted and told me that he'd plotted to kill me and Amos knew about it. That's kind of how I ended up here. Ah, the ex that you've been avoiding talking about. I nodded my head. And how did that make you feel, knowing that your ex and your current knew each other and were conspiring to kill you? My chest started to tighten, and a lump grew in my throat. I rubbed my throat while clearing it at the same time to release the lump. It hurt so bad, deeply, to my core. I'd told him my darkest, deepest secrets. I'd fallen in love with him and trusted him. Shit, he'd shown me that he'd do anything to protect me. All of that and his sex. Shit, I was gone off the deep end. I never thought that he'd do something like that. Our story was the perfect enemies to lovers story. I truly had concocted a whole life with him, even though he told me that we should take it day by day. When I heard that, I just spiraled out of control.
in my defense, I told him that I didn't have another heartbreak in me. What happened when you spiraled? That's when I was nearly killed by the two people that I was telling you about. I remember now Amos said something about them drugging and raping me. Honestly, I am so glad that memory is lost somewhere in Cokeland. She gasped. Oh my God, where are they now? And what's Cokeland? Cokeland is the part of my brain where things I did while I was high go to that I don't remember. I'm not sure of their location. That's something that I'll have to ask Amos if I ever talk to him again. You two had a conversation about it. You two seemed pretty comfortable at the hospital. Well, he told me how it all went down while I was in the hospital. I couldn't get mad and shout like I wanted to because of my heart, but it was kind of easy to forgive him once I learned that he had actually given my ex the amount of money that his shit was worth. Sorry. He just wanted me because he couldn't have me. She was speechless. And don't ask me where he is because I don't know that either. I'd have to ask Amos that, too. So I might be a little confused. You forgave him for the plot to kill you because he paid what you owed? Not for actually taking the job to begin with. Was the hate between you all that strong that he would harm his sister-in-law's best friend? Long story less long. Yes, I laughed. I can laugh now because they're happily in love, but I actually hit Amos in his face 3 times as hard as I could and ran off. He wanted to kill me for real then. I stopped laughing when I noticed her staring at me. This is my first time seeing you laugh. I'm really goofy, but ain't shit been funny these last few weeks. I was struggling. I am struggling. The clearer my mind gets, the more I realize that it probably would have never worked between us anyway. In my opinion, he didn't even like me for real. He felt sorry for me, coupled with the fact that I was literally stuck in his house. So fucking was inevitable. So it's best I cut the cord between us now. She wiped her mouth with her napkin. Wow, that is a major decision, Christina. Are you sure that is the decision that you want to make right now? You've told me that you believe that he's one of your biggest supporters. You're an addict. You're going to need as much support as you can get. I looked at her. Ember, believe me, it's for the best. I'd be an embarrassment to him anyway, probably. I'm so glad I don't have my phone or I'd probably go into a depression. My calendar was booked for months and I just abandoned them. I'll probably never be a tattoo artist again. Maybe I should just move away and start over. She perked up. You do know that after an addict completes rehab, it is recommended that they change environments. So, you know, a move might not be bad for you, but it's also a huge responsibility. You'll have to be responsible for finding a meeting group and a therapist there if you need one. It's a huge step that takes a lot of thought. I have no idea where I would live. I'd been in Georgia all my life. Sure, I'd visited a lot of places stateside and internationally, but I'd never visited a place that made me want to say that I'd move there. Honestly, I didn't know what I would do if I didn't see Val every day when I'd seen her nearly every day of my life since we were little girls. You're right, but why do I have to stop smoking weed and drinking alcohol? Why are you looking at me like that? Because you know that those are gateway drugs. You won't even be able to have a glass of wine for a while until you're strong enough. Well, I guess you're right. She looked across the room at my blank easel. You haven't been drawing? No inspiration. The last muse I had was him. You should try painting from a clear head. Even if it's just a few lines, maybe something will come to you. I looked at the easel. You're right. I'm sorry, by the way, for talking to you and the staff like that. I shouldn't have done that. I accept your apology, but you have to apologize to the other staff on your own. I'll do that. She stood up and wiped her mouth with her napkins. Thank you for letting me have dinner with you. Tomorrow's going to be a better day. All you have to do is take it one day at a time. I nodded my head. When she left the room, I finished eating and went to sit at my easel. It had been a long time since I'd painted sober. I didn't even know where to begin. I wasn't angry, so I wasn't in the mood to draw anything dark or grim. I wasn't happy because I'd rather be in my own bed, but for the first time in a long time, I felt sober. And that's the end of her crazy-ass chapter. All right, y'all. Let me get the next timestamp. Hold on. All right, y'all. Did I miss anybody coming in? Because, child, I'm trying to say.
Hold on, y'all. Oh.
Well. All right, I'm trying to see. Did I miss anything? Huh? Huh? Oh. Well, thanks for letting me know, because I didn't know. I'm laughing at them from last night before I get this next timestamp. Okay, I'm trying to see. Wait a minute. The Nikki Parker. Okay. That lady know damn well Chris don't like her. Chris don't like her damn self, right? Two things are true here. Dare head ass. Right? Chris is delusional. Oh my God. Okay, let me get this. Y'all cold blooded, boy. All right. Hold on. Damn. Right, she can't have no weed, no liquor. I mean, it's for her own good. But I'm kind of annoyed. I hate that they tell people that they need to, you know, relocate to another city. You know, I hate that. Mm-mm. They think, oh, you don't know where to go to find drugs. But Black therapists and counselors, what the fuck is happening with my throat? All right, got it. So my whole point is that they think white therapists and counselors seem to think that moving to another city means you won't be able to find drugs. But Black folks understand that every city in every state has a hood. Yes, it does. And Black folks know if you want to find what you're looking for, that probably ain't no goddamn good for you, but could quite possibly be good to you, regardless to your status. Yeah, you just go to the hood, baby. That's where it is, you know. It's just a fact, you know. You got to argue with the universe about that. And I won't be nowhere around while you doing that. I promise you, I won't. I can't goddamn see. All right, hold on. Oh, maybe if I pull this thing closer, like, duh. Nope, didn't help. Shit's still blurry. All right, let's get on to the next fucking chapter, child. I don't give a fuck. I can't see, so I'm just gonna do the damn fucking thing and call it a day, damn it. All right, y'all, I got my time stamp. We just gotta let this shit count. 5 seconds is what it is. Chapter 14, Amos. Hours earlier, leaving the rehab facility with Chris in tears like that really fucked with me bad. I wanted to take her, but if Ember said she needed to stay, then she needed to stay. Just from the way she acted with me in her room, I knew that she needed to stay as well. When she told me that she would never talk to me again, that shit hurt, even though I didn't believe her. No doubt she'd be mad, but she'd also be thanking me later. Ember told me she'd give me an update before she went home for the night. From one fire to the next is what crossed my mind, pulling back into my dad's driveway to see him standing outside talking to two men with their backs to me. When I got out of the car, my dad looked past them and waved at me. They were finishing up their conversation by the time I'd made it to them. I eyed them both as they walked by me. He pushed one hand in his pocket and wrapped his arm around my neck with the other while we walked into the house. Everything good with Miss Chase? How did you know that was the reason that I left? seems like she's the only thing that can get you to move fast these days. You didn't miss much. The food is just now getting put on the table. You know Steven can't just watch someone else cook, so he wanted to remake a dish. Yeah, I stopped him before we made it out of the hallway. What was that back there? You can't talk your way out of that. I wasn't trying to talk my way out of anything because I wasn't going to tell you anyway. I look taken aback. Now, let's go eat. Man, fuck that shit, Dad. You fucked up, stupid ass. That's so crazy. What the hell? But anyway, all right. He started to walk away, but I didn't move. It wouldn't have anything to do with you crying earlier, right? He whipped his head around before his body followed and yoked me up against the wall. His grip on my arm was tight, but I could get away from him if I really wanted to. But I'd never disrespect my father that way. What the fuck did you just say to me? You heard what I said, Dad. You've never seen me cry. No, not before today I hadn't. We eyed each other intensely before he released my arm. You know, I straightened out the part of the sweater that he'd bunched up. I just told Christina that it was okay to feel. I'm sure Dr. Wallace told you the same once, and that's why you were comfortable with crying in front of her. He didn't say anything. He stuffed his hands into his pockets. Because I was about to say something. What the fuck did she tell him he could feel? But anyway, that's how they got there in the first fucking place. She's leaving the country, he said solemnly, with Henry. They've been talking for a while, dating, and he's convinced her to take a job working at a new hospital in the DR. I'd shot the idea down for a while now, but I guess seeing me with your mother just took her over the edge. I deserve it. Damn, Dad. Yeah, I know. So, what are you gonna do? You're gonna ask me that with your mother sitting less than 20 feet away? Dad, you were crying. I've never seen you cry in my life. Sad, but what you were doing upstairs? No. And I think there is something that you should know about. Dad, Duke appeared. Amos, when did you get back? Just a second ago. I looked back at Dad. Why you never told us, well, me, about that? I thought it was kind of implied. She basically lived here. We don't have to talk about that now. Y'all, I'm reading it how the fucking conversation go. I promise you. The shit is staggered like that with ellipses in between. Anyway, we don't have to talk about that now. We're ready to begin eating. Amos, is everything okay? I nodded my head. It will be. We can table that conversation. I'm hungry. He walked away, leaving me and Duke standing there. He was talking to some dudes outside. You don't think? I don't know. It won't get discussed right now, though. When I walked into the room, my empty seat was across from Irvy and the baby. Duke sat where my grandfather would normally sit. He wasn't really feeling the extra company, so he was more than likely in his man cave watching ESPN. My dad stood at the head of the table with his glass of wine in his hand. I would like to thank you all for attending, and to the new faces, welcome to the family. The tradition is that we go around the room and say one thing that we're thankful for. I'll start. Family. I'm thankful for my family. And pretty much everyone went around saying that they were thankful for family and love. After Stephen said the prayer, the servers started taking the lids off the food. There were 3 big turkeys, 2 hams, and various side dishes. Everything looked and smelled good as fucking. I was hungry as hell. For a while, all you could hear was the clinking of plates and people muttering about how good the food was. No lie, I wasn't good with holidays because of my mother not being here to celebrate with us. I never thought that I'd still feel empty with my mother finally here celebrating a holiday with us. That damn Christina. My mind was on her heavy. I still didn't believe that she'd never talk to me again, but what if she didn't? If she never spoke to me again, she'd think that was it. She was the type of woman who would think that it would be okay to have her new man or whoever coming up in this house for a holiday dinner, not knowing that I'd blast his head smooth right in front of her. Oh, my God. Oh, shit. All right. I shouldn't be thinking about that while I was surrounded by family, but I was trying to make that girl my family. I didn't even know how long I'd been in my own world until Duke nudged my knee. I looked at him across the table. What? He nodded his head down the table. When I turned my head, Laura stared at me with a blank look on her face. I was in my own world. What did you say? I asked if you've checked on my daughter. I have. Can you tell me how she's doing since she's not talking to me right now? That's not my fault. Duke nudged my knee harder than he did the first time. He was staring at me through squinted eyes, making me shrug my shoulder a little. I didn't say it was your fault, Amos. You sure about that? I picked up my glass of water and took a few sips. Do you need to take a break? Duke asked lowly. I am fine. Amos, I don't want you to think that, excuse me, we're trying to have dinner. Now is not the time to have that conversation. No offense, my mom said. Everyone turned their heads toward her. Laura was the last one to look at her, and she definitely rolled her neck when she looked toward her. None taken. I haven't had the chance to talk to him because I don't have his phone number. Well, after dinner, ask him for his phone number so you two can have a chat, not over this delicious turkey. I'm sorry. I didn't understand what you said. My mother picked her glass up and threw back the rest of the wine that was at the bottom. Oh, I'm reading like a woman. Sorry. I didn't know how many she'd had, but it was too damn much. Well, you are one more well away from, Stephen interjected. Has anyone seen Dr. Wallace? I thought I saw her come in. Did something happen? She had to leave, Angel said. I felt like I was in one of those stupid-ass housewives show that Christina got me low-key invested in. Several awkward moments of silence went by. My mother reached over my father and grabbed his glass of wine. He was so out of it that he didn't even recognize what she'd done. When I cut my eyes to Duke, he was slightly shaking his head. I'm sorry, Amos. I don't want to cause any confusion. There isn't any confusion, Miss Chase. I normally don't take too well to people trying to attack me, so excuse my coldness. Tried to attack you? Why? My mom asked. You didn't say that, Amos. Oh, Lord, Angel whispered and tossed the rest of her drink back. I need a shot. Let me go grab that, she said, and left the table. Laura set her utensils down on her plate. Oh, Lord. Oh, Lord is really in the book, y'all. Oh, I'm gonna fucking notice whatever in the filthy fuck it is I'm supposed to notice. Oh, I will be scrolling up. And thank God for cute little chubby cheek, tiny black baby, curly haired Jesus. I don't have to worry about it. If you delete it, I'll still see it. And I'm going back up. And I got a feeling I'm gonna be adding some names a couple more times to the goddamn hog tie list. All right, here we go. Here we go. Right, all fuck is right. All right. Laura sat her utensils down on her plate. Oh, Lord. Well, as a mother, when you find out that the man your daughter is in love with also conspired with her ex to, I didn't conspire anything. What do you call it? Anais, say something, Irvy whispered. I believe this is a conversation between Amos and Miss Chase and Mrs. Duke. Duke shot her a look, making her straighten her shoulders a little. Look, the most important thing is that she and I have moved past it, and we're going to be okay. And that's all that matters, honey. Christina's dad, Chris said, while patting Laura's arm. And let me tell you something. This is some bullshit at this fucking Thanksgiving dinner, because the way I would have been meeting motherfuckers at the table, you do not even realize. I could tell that she was pissed. Chris was doing his best to keep her calm. Yeah, I forgot her father. Christina's father's name is Christopher. And her mammy's name is Laura with her funky back ass. Anyway, we don't like her. You got a lot of air in your chest. Say what's on your mind, I said. I sat up in the chair. Amos, Duke growled. I don't think that you really love my daughter and that you just feel guilty for her relapse and the loss of her child. Chris was visibly embarrassed. Everybody else was looking around, trying to see whether they should leave or stay. Angel threw back another shot. That was my child too, Laura. It's Mrs. Chase to you. And the only person or people that should feel guilty about anything at this table is... My mom used her fork to point it at Laura and Chris. Oh my God, Irvy whispered. Is she drunk? Catherine, Duke called her name. What does that mean, Mrs. Duke? I'm curious. Chris asked her. Cat, drop it, my dad warned her. She tucked her lips in. Don't get quiet now. Say what's on your mind, Laura said. My husband told me to hush, so that's what I'm going to do because I know how to listen. Angel shook her head and poured herself another shot, then poured me one. I picked mine up and threw it back. It burned all the way down and was just what I needed. Listen, in order to, all right, here we go. No. I want to know what that means because I don't understand how this got turned around on me and my husband when your son was the cause of all of this. I get that you want to take up for your son, but the facts are the facts. Mom cleared her throat. You ever thought about not forcing your daughter to watch you nearly kill your husband and then forcing her to watch you love that same man like there's not another dick in the world? Both my dad and Duke stood up at the same time. Enough of this. Enough of you. Go into my dad's office now. Duke pointed toward the door. She stood up. You two are the cause of your daughter's relapse. Not my son. He saved her life more than you two can ever say. What kind of woman gets back with the man who had two kids with her best friend? Laura stood up and grabbed the knife, pointing it at her. Bitch, let me tell you one motherfucking thing. Do not ever fix your lips to talk about me, my husband, my parenting, or any of the decisions that I made when you dipped on your kids. I am not too far removed from having to shank a bitch. Everybody jumped up and held their hands out as if that would stop them if they really wanted to rumble. I just knew that Ashton Kutcher was about to jump out with the camera. I couldn't believe what the fuck was happening before my eyes. Duke started around the table, yanking our mom by her arm, dragging her away. Angel, Amos, Duke called after us. We pushed back from the table and followed my father out of the dining room. Duke was down the hallway, still with a death grip on our mom's arm. He opened the door and pushed her in with us following close behind. My dad stood by the door as we walked in. He slammed the door so hard that he nearly popped it off the hinges. My mom was sitting in the chair rubbing where Duke had yoked her up. My dad walked slowly across the room until he sat behind his desk. It reminded me of how it used to be when we were younger. Duke stood by his desk with me standing behind one of the chairs, and Angel sat cross-legged in the chair by the wall. Duke was always ready to jump and defend us, regardless of if it was one of us that fucked up something. Someone, anyone, better start talking before I lose my goddamn mind, my dad spoke, cool, calm, and collectedly. Our eyes darted between each other before we all started speaking at the same time before telling each other to go ahead, but nobody said anything. My dad chuckled. Now you all want to be a choir. I'm out there talking about I'm thankful for my family, and my family is acting like they don't have any damn sense. He looked at Mom, and I am very disappointed in you. Why? If she was about to accuse our boy of, your son can handle himself. You know that. Don't you ever in your life speak out of turn to them again, especially when she doesn't need to be questioning anyone's parenting, right, Duke? I looked at him and he was slightly shaking his head, telling me that it wasn't the right moment. I know, I raised y'all to stick together, but I am sick of the little buddy-buddy secret side shit that you two been doing for the last few weeks. What is going on? I cut my eyes to my mom and she looked scared out of her mind. By the way her eyes looked like they were about to pop out of her head, I knew that she was scared as hell. If there's something that I need to know, please tell me. Mom stared at Duke with pleading eyes before tearing up. His eyes swept the floor before looking back at her. Anias the Third, my dad called him. When he called him by his real name, he knew that shit was about to get real. Tears slipped down her face and she swatted them away. I'll do it. Kids, can your father and I have the room, please? We didn't move for a few moments before we left the office and stood outside the door as if we would be able to hear something. Angel and I used to keep our ear pressed to his door to hear what they would be talking about. This time, even Duke stood around waiting to see what would happen. Dad had the thickest wooden door that he could put on it, so it was hard to hear. I didn't want to tell him today, Duke whispered. Why not? You were never going to say anything to Dad about it, I whispered back. Shh, Angel shushed us. I was just going to talk to her on my own, eventually. Shh, damn! What the fuck? my dad shouted, followed by a loud crash. Duke reached around us and pushed the door open. My mother was on her knees in front of him, holding her face in her hands. He didn't even acknowledge us when we rushed into the office. He glared down at her with his fists balled up at his sides. His chest heaved up and down hard and fast as fuck. "Dad," I called out to him. "Duke, why didn't you tell me that your mother did that to you?" It sounded like he was trying to catch his breath. He was pissed. "It didn't matter then, and it don't matter now. You hit her? She told me to," he said, and moved away from her, nearly making her fall forward. "And I should have. I wish I could, but I still love her, and she's still my wife." He walked by us, heading for the door. "I'm gonna go enjoy the rest of my meal. Do whatever you want with her, but get her out of my house. If I see you while I'm still this mad," I think he meant her, because there's no her. "But if I see her while I'm still this mad, I'm liable to kill her." I walked over to her to help her up. When she looked up, her face was red and wet with tears. Me and Duke helped her to her feet. "He needed to knock me out because I deserved it. I should have never left you guys. Not how I did." She started to cry. "I'll take her home since I shouldn't be here either." Me, Duke, and Angel helped her out the house and into my car. "Okay, I'll text y'all later," I told them before they walked back into the house. As soon as I got in the car, I turned the music up and sped out of the driveway. I wanted to ride in silence, but I could tell by the way my mom kept looking at me that she wanted to say something, so I turned the music down. I really messed up, didn't I? At least everything is out in the open. Everybody has taken their anger out on me. It's up to them to forgive me, right? I didn't respond. "And I didn't like the way that she was talking to you, trying to insinuate that you were the reason she relapsed, like they didn't play a part in it too. I should have just kept my mouth closed. I had no right. It needed to be said. Once everyone calms down, we'll have a formal sit down. Are you an alcoholic?" "No, I just had too much to drink, even though I knew it already and I shouldn't be mad. It sucked to see my husband pouting over his mistress." I looked at her and then back at the road. "I'm no fool. They both went missing around the same time. He came back pissed and stayed pissed. Excused himself to talk to those men that pulled up. I am not a fool, Amos. He's going to do what he did before. Stop her from leaving him. She's had opportunity after opportunity to leave this state. I made sure of it, but each time he shot it down." "What do you mean you made sure of it?" "Being a Duke, I'd made some connections as well. I'd slip her name into some hats." She laughed. "And each time he made sure her ass never went anywhere. I was slightly embarrassed. All our friends are their friends now. Watching her talk to them and ignore me, it was a lot of take in." I think she meant it was a lot to take in, but it says it was a lot of take in. "Being back here is a lot to get used to. You, Angel, and LD are not little anymore and are completely different people. I'll get used to it." I didn't have anything to say to that. I wasn't about to tell her that he was crying over her because that would hurt her feelings even worse than what she was feeling now. "Well, if it makes you feel better, I'll let you know that this Thanksgiving was the most eventful one we've had in a long time. You got that right." And here's a break in the chapter. Fuck. And 11 minutes left in the chapter. Oh, God. Child, I need to go back up here because I'm so goddamn nosy. Hey, church lady. I missed you, child. I saw you and I was coming down the line to get to you, child. Did I speak to you, M. Royce? Yes, I spoke to you and Buns. All right, so then I spoke to Peanut. Little did I know she was going to cause a fucking problem in here. There's the problem right there. All right. I spoke to Yaya, but for whatever reason, I miss you, church lady, and I apologize because there you are. Hey, church lady, welcome, darling. Thank you for being here, lovey. I appreciate you. And hey, Ebony, and I think I got everybody. Nope, because then I spoke to Shakara, and I'm trying to see what the trouble is. Right, I saw the trouble. Now, what the fuck was y'all saying after that? Okay. Says Saki came back on so fast, I got too tickled. And she said, so I can nut up in here tonight, Popeye. What the hell? Right, this is why all five of our asses is getting y'all on the list to be hogtied now. Right, Christina need to let her mama go. I just listened. Y'all funny as shit. Yep. There you go. I told you, Buck, that shit was funny. Oh, number three for wifey. Okay, so three for Jay, two for Buck. All right, I got you. Let me keep on going. That shit had me screaming. All right, Kaylin. Here we go. Mm-hmm. Oh, she got to listen again. Yeah. Okay. Child, I can't help that. But you still on the fucking list. Because y'all starting shit. Okay, I'm still going. I caught that part when you noticed I meant literal water bags. I just clicked off right before the very end. Okay, yep. Okay, I'm going. I caught the dare head ass. I thought Kasaki, I out of commission. I could cut up a little. No, ma'am. But I see she's on to me. Exactly. She only see half of the book. Oh, Kaylin. Okay, Kaylin, I got you. Oh, boy. Wow. Let me just say this. What a difference a day makes. Okay, Kaylin. 24 little hours. All right, baby girl, I see you now. Oh, you think you know a motherfucker, boy, but in 24 hours, yeah, I see what you did there. Yeah, right. I got you. Mm-hmm. Yep. That's what she fucking meant right there with the hole you dig. There you go. Oh, chuckle it the fuck up, all of you. Mm-hmm. Yep. And she called it the Slick Rick, y'all. Do y'all see the bullshit? See how these people do me? She's talking about last one. Look at Kaylin. Oh, God. Church lady said, y'all know y'all are so wrong. I'm telling when I stop laughing. Ah, church lady done got added to the list because you shouldn't have fucking laughed. You should have threw your body backwards to keep from laughing. That's how you get out of laughing. Just act like you just got lightheaded and fainted. Just throw your body backwards or grab your knee and say, oh, shit, right? That's how you do it. But that's all right. So now you on the list. Church lady done came up here and got on the list. Oh, yeah, I'm going to notice whether you stay still or not. Mm-hmm. Come on, church lady, don't say nothing. Oh, my God. This is what parents feel like when their kids go to church and be like, my mama be cussing in the kitchen about my daddy. She said my daddy ain't shit. Right. That's what kids be telling in Sunday school. You need to go to Sunday school with your children and see what the fuck they be telling. That's why the sisters and the saints be laughing at you when you bring your ass in there in them two tight ass bodycon dresses. It's all right, though. Now I know why. I'm sitting here eating and rubbing my hands like Birdman. Uh-huh. Let me get my wine. It's going down with Saki C's comments. Exactly, L Boogie. I'm telling you, every single one of these motherfuckers think they is slicker than snot on a ceramic tile floor. Baby, you ain't slick enough. I'm sperm on a whale's back. I out-slick your ass. That's how we do that. Yeah, I am reading. Oh, yeah, we real Slick Rick tonight. Yeah. I got you. She told me you ain't got to do that. Next time, step right. Like that one time I was supposed to get an ass whooping. My mama came home. She was ready to fuck me up. I was like, I saved you my donut from school. She told me, oh, yeah, thanks. And I owe you an ass whooping, baby. Yeah. Next time. I ate my goddamn donut. Fuck, I look like saving my donut and still getting my ass beat. No, God. I just screamed and now I'm running around the kitchen laughing. All of y'all, y'all need to be in, right, only see half the bullshit sent me. Yep. Oh, yeah, he repeated it. Thanks, Buck. Mm-hmm. I take one of yours off because you, Nah, you know what? Fuck that. I'm leaving yours on. And I'm adding an extra one because you did repeat it. Oh, snitching ass. Nobody likes a snitch, Buck. Buck like, what the hell? Yep.
I'm adding it. I don't know why it's funny to you. Right. That's funny. Go ahead. Chuckle it up. Rolling up now, getting a good side of my ass. You better get it ready because I'm definitely connecting with the fat party ass this evening. Whoa, this the family dinner from house party. No. That's okay. It's all right. Yep. I don't give a damn about you playing gospel. Buck, she putting you in a headlock first. I'm not worried. No, everybody get tied up. Everybody get tied up. I'm finna find me some corduroy pants. They keep the belt from stinging. Girl, with two pair of long johns underneath. I know you lying. Right. She just gonna find you in damn show is. I'm finna run. By the time she catch me, she'll be a little tired before she get to you. Nah, because I was about to say, what I do is send one through your leg, and then you'll stop. I ain't gonna be tired. Or either that, or I'll just put my damn foot on your damn knee until I catch my breath. I'm gonna catch you. Think she'll forget if I do my best 1-2 to her favorite song? Nope. Nope. So church lady said, I thought I heard a familiar tune in the background, Kaylin. Here we go. I got pins and vapes for you. I do not accept bribes. No, God. No, for real, Miss Church Lady. I need all my blessings for tonight. Hey, Miss Pretty. Welcome, boo. Thank you for being here, lovey. I appreciate you. All right, I'm getting back to it. And just, girl, you could be in your prayer closet all night. Yep, joy cometh in the morning. My new name is Joy, and I'm coming. Right, so get ready. Buns talking about, I'm safe. Right, Buns ain't saying shit. She talking about, I just smiled a little. I didn't actually laugh. Too bad. Nope. All right, let me go back to the book. Yeah, buddy. Everybody cackling and kicking. Thank you to those of you who stuck around for me getting my hog tie list together. I appreciate y'all. It was after midnight, and I was sitting up in bed trying to keep my eyes open, waiting for a call or text from Ember. I'd been trying to keep myself busy, but I couldn't wait any longer, so I called her. She picked up on the first ring. Hello? Ember, sorry it's late. I was waiting on an update regarding Chris. What happened? She got quiet. Hello? Well, Amos, I have to inform you that I can no longer update you on Christina. Why not? She took you off the list. What did you say to her? See, this is the bullshit I'm talking about. This is why I said I wasn't getting invested in this bullshit. Because here this weird-ass bitch go, ain't this the nigga that's paying for the shit? Or is she paying for her fucking self? That's what I need to. I want everybody to see why wifey now has 10. Because sometimes you just have to up the stick on a nigga until they get it together. It's all right. Right. To everybody that's not used to this, yeah, our bad. Yeah. It's okay. It usually goes left around here. There we go. It's okay. So Christina took him off the list. I thought he was paying for her fucking treatment. The audacity. The audacity. What the fuck? And this bitch actually let her do. She should have told her, you don't need to make a decision like this while you're angry. This man. I didn't say anything to her. It's what she wanted to do. I asked her if she was sure twice, and she said yes. I only recall reading you asking her that once, ma'am. So you a liar. This bitch lying. Maybe she'll change her mind. Maybe she won't, but this is as far as we go, Amos. Wait, good night, she said, and ended the call. I slammed my phone on the nightstand and slid down in bed, pulling the covers over my head.
Even when I did the right thing, I still got the short end of the stick. Now, I fucking saw why my brother fucked escorts for as long as he did. They could never get under your fucking skin. Child, listen. Ugh, this is crazy. All right. 2 weeks later, I was sitting against the wall in Christina's bathroom. Duke had come over here, interrupting me. It was time for me to take a break anyway. Are you okay, Amos? Duke was leaning against the sink with his arms folded across his chest. You haven't said much to anyone in a couple of weeks. You haven't even been to work. Granted, everything is caught up, but I am worried about you. He was right. Ever since that botched Thanksgiving dinner, I'd been staying home and out of the way. No matter what my mom told me, I felt like all this shit was my fault. If I hadn't seen my mother in California, I wouldn't have brought her here. If I hadn't taken my ass to that prison, Chris wouldn't have relapsed. No matter the plot twist in the story, it all led back to me. Shit like that weighed on a person. And on top of that, Chris had been true to her word so far and cut contact off with me completely. I'd called and texted Ember so much that she'd blocked me from her phone. For the first few days, I called Healing Souls every other hour on the hour, trying to see if I could bribe a person to tell me how she was doing or at least send her a message from me, but nobody took the bait. You know, I offered her $1 million to give me one update, and she said no. One measly update, and she said no, Duke sighed. I'd gone from rational to irrational. For a couple nights, I used my drone to see if Christina would come to the window like last time, but she didn't. A thought that popped up in my mind was that Healing Souls was a cult, and Ember was the woman that pretended to be sweet, leading the girls in and holding them hostage until they brainwashed them. I was all on the internet trying to find at least one person who would agree with me so I wouldn't feel too crazy, but every fucking review on the place was stellar. The last resort was just to pull up and see what was going on. By then, I was looking like a madman. I hadn't slept, barely ate, and hadn't gotten a haircut. I'd gotten in the facility claiming that I had something for Ember. I'd caught a glimpse of her doing yoga, and my fucking heart skipped a beat. When she noticed me, she stared at me like she'd seen a ghost. It was like she was scared of me. Ember had me escorted off of the property, telling me that I was hindering her recovery. And maybe I was, but fuck, I missed her. It's been 2 weeks, Duke. He looked around the bathroom. I'm sure he wanted to change the conversation. And this is what you've been doing to keep busy? It looks nice. You're really great at this. After I realized that Christina had really cut me off, I'd come over to her house to redo her bathroom to make it look like a mini version of mine, with the shower and standalone tub she loved so much. It wasn't too much of a hassle, plus it kept me busy and from thinking about her. I hope that she liked it. How's Catherine? She's fine. Been getting on my fucking nerves. I don't know how my house is not large enough to get away from her. How's Dad? He shrugged his shoulders. Much like you, he's been trying to keep busy. Dr. Wallace's house was empty by the time his men got over there, and he doesn't know where she went. He's worried about you more, though. I'm fine. I'll go see him tomorrow. When his phone started ringing, he reached into his pocket and pulled it out. It's Irvy. She just came from Chris's first family visit. I stood up and rushed over to him, prompting him to hold his arm out. Acting like a fiend or something. Answer it! Hold on, nigga. Put it on speaker. Shut up. He answered the phone and put it on speaker. Hey, Ma. Hi, baby, she spoke back. She got quiet and I could hear her sniff. Duke pushed himself off the sink. Irvy, what's wrong? Is everything okay? Something happened with Chris? Anais, everything is fine. I'm just overcome with emotions. Her hair has grown out. She's put on a few pounds. She looks happier, brighter. She's approaching 30 days clean. I am just so, so, so happy. She looks so beautiful. I can't even explain it. And she is still silly as hell. We had such a good time. I tapped his arm. Ask her about me, I mouthed. That's good, baby. I told you that she was gonna do it. When I tapped his arm again, he shot me a look. What was the meeting about? The meeting was just her making amends, apologizing for things she may have done or said while she was under the influence. After that, we all started talking, and I was catching her up on some of the drama some of her favorite housewives were going through. Tapping his arm, I mouthed, ask me about me. I think she meant, he meant ask about me. But if she put ask me about me, I'm reading the fucking shit the way it is. And he shrugged me off. He covered the speaker of the phone. Stop tapping me, he hissed. There was one thing that I didn't like that she said, but I had to be supportive of what she said. And what was that? You don't have to tell me if you don't want to. She told me that she was thinking about moving and starting over somewhere else, and I don't want her to move away. What? I whispered loudly. She can't move. I would not let her move, no matter how much she fought me on that. I would hold her hostage and would give no fucks about it. What you doing, bae? Talking to Amos. She paused. Oh, tell him I said hey, and that his nephew misses him. I threw my hands up and walked away from him because he wasn't going to ask about me. You didn't tell her about the Thanksgiving fiasco, did you? Yeah, I checked with Ember beforehand, though. She didn't do anything but shake her head, and we started talking about something else. She's actually having her family meeting with her parents tomorrow. She says that she feels good about it and is open to listening, so we're one step away from having a perfect Christmas. A redo of Thanksgiving, if you will. Anyway, I am on my way home to relieve Dom of baby duty. When will you be home? Not long after you. Be careful. I love you. Love you back, she said, and ended the call. Duke looked at me and shrugged his shoulders. See, she hadn't asked about you. You know things don't always work out the way that you want them to, and that is something that you might just have to deal with. That's easy for you to say. You have the fiancé and the baby. I picked up the paintbrush, dipped it in the bowl, and ran a line down the wall. Amos, is that what this is about? You're not trying to force this thing with Christina because I have a child and will be getting married soon, are you? I ignored him and kept painting the wall. Amos, answer me. I kept quiet. You do realize that I am 10 whole years older than you. At 31, I was exactly where you are right now, working and putting the company first, Amos. I actually really do love Christina. She gets me and I get her. In the beginning, seeing you so happy disgusted me because that's not who we are, but the shit looks good on you. Having Christina in my house, mostly to myself, made me realize that happiness looks and feels good. I want that. I'm so fixated on her because I've seen her at her lowest of lows. And I didn't feel any different about her. This love shit is confusing as hell on everything I fucking love. If I could just turn this shit off, I would. I don't know how people choose to have these types of feelings about someone. Me either, nigga, okay? I love your ass, but I'd be just fine without you, nigga. Right. That's me. Maybe I'm too much like a dude, but not this dude, because he kind of fucking love struck right now. Anyway, Duke chuckled. How can I help? I turned and looked at him. Will you help me hold her hostage if she tries to move? Duke cocked his head to the side, making me chuckle. Figured. I was joking, but I don't know. I'll let you know if I come up with something. Okay, get home safe. We bumped elbows before he left the house. And it's another break in the chapter. This nigga here. Love sick ass fucking puppy. Nigga. I don't know. I feel like if you know somebody love you, it's just certain shit you don't do to them, you know? Period. All right, I'll get back at it in a second. This is why I didn't want to read this shit. For this bitch to pull this shit right here. It was after midnight when I walked in my house. I'd worked until I gave myself a banging ass headache. At least the bathroom was almost done, though. The project did what I needed it to do, and that was to keep my mind off that woman. My house was quiet, which was unusual, because over the last couple weeks, I'd come in the house to my mother playing the piano loudly. Walking into the kitchen, my mother stood at the island pouring herself a glass of wine. You're early tonight. Did you get finished? No, I probably have a couple days left on it. I have to finish painting and then put the mirror up and I'll be done. What were you doing? How many glasses of wine have you had tonight? Her eyes were red and glossy. Anything new with Christina? No. Oh, she told Irby that she was thinking about moving and starting over. It's been 2 weeks and she didn't even ask Irby about me. I think it might be over. Answer my question. Are you going to give up? Mom, I have. Why are you continuously avoiding my question? What's going on? She pointed her head toward the oversized envelope that was in front of her. I snatched it up and it had my address on it and her name on it. Opening it, I pulled the papers out and divorce decree popped out at me in bold letters. Scanning the top paper, I saw that my mom and dad's names were on there. Oh, I shrugged my shoulders because I didn't know what to say, really, knowing everything that I knew now. Did you know about this? I shook my head. I haven't seen or talked to him much since Thanksgiving. You don't think this is cowardly? We've only been married for over 40 years and have 3 children, and you were absent for how many of those years? You expected him not to move on or something? He finally told you about the doctor, huh? I told you that she was a mistress. You didn't believe me. I never really paid attention to that, Ma. So what are you going to do? Nothing. I'm going to sign the paper, son. I have you all now and my grandbaby. You know, Duke scheduled a meeting with me so we can talk about my intentions. He said that he wasn't going to let me run in and out of his son's life. So that's a good start. Angel texted me a couple of days ago to check on me. I'll move out of here. I got my own place. Look on the 4th page. Ma, you know you don't have to move out of here. Oh, yes, I do, because when that little woman you love gets out of rehab, she's going to be hornier than I don't know what. I don't want to be a bother. Flipping to the 4th page, I saw that my father was buying her condo downtown and giving her unlimited use to one of his black cards. Shit, that's all I need. You buy me a condo, right? I ain't even got to move into the bitch because I already live there. And I got unlimited use of one of your black cards? Nigga, Amazon and Walmart and Sam's Club has everything a bitch could ever need. That and DooneyandBurke.com. Right, that part. You know. You take your dick elsewhere because I'm a fuck who I'm a fuck. And there ain't going to be a goddamn thing you could do about it. But hell, that's good enough for me. Child, listen, I need that shit in writing. So if you don't do what you supposed to do, nigga, you go to jail. Right, that's what I want. The fuck? All right. He's still taking care of you, so that's good. Yes, more than I deserve, honestly. We had a few good, fun weeks. Oh, my God. What are you gonna do when I start dating again? Ma, I don't even want to think about that, honestly. I'm going to go shower and get into bed. My head is pounding. Okay, good night. And don't worry about Christina because that doctor ain't here to take care of you, she said and smiled. Kidding, but she'll come around eventually. Just don't try to force anything. Let it happen naturally. Didn't you tell me that's how y'all happened before? Yeah, you right. Naturally. Let it happen naturally. And that's the end of that chapter. All right. Oh, dude, Jesus, child. She told me I'm already overdrawn. Oh, yeah. All right. That was the end of that chapter, y'all. Child, listen. Oh, they ain't going to die. I'm just going to beat their ass till it roll like okra. And after that, they can get on up and go on where they got to go. But I damn sure ain't going to fight nobody. So what I'm going to do is hog time so I can get at that ass and do what I need to do, which is beat it till it roll like okra, and then get right on up out of there. Right. That's all. Yep. Keep them hog tied, then you ain't got to worry about it. All right, so I got the time stamp. We just got to wait for it to count down. And it's going to be a second, so you got time enough to run and get you a little something, a little cool drink. I ain't forgot that shit either. Right, a little cool drink. Yeah. So go ahead, because I got to wet my whistle with my coffee and my water. Oh, it feel good, depending on who you ask. I'm chocolate, baby, not vanilla. Feel good to me, but you know, to you vanilla people, probably not so much. Would you like it? Probably not. Not to that extreme. No, you wouldn't like it. I promise you, you wouldn't. You would not like it. No. You'd be calling for somebody to come pick you up. Yeah, you'd be like, could you come pick me up? I don't want to spend the night. I don't want to spend the night no more. Oh, Lord have mercy, child. All right. So a few more seconds, y'all. Lord, I get up here and tell y'all too much of my goddamn business. I used to tell my folks, stay out my goddamn business. Right. Please. Oh, Lord. Child, listen. I'm not paying no attention to none of y'all. All right, I'm going to give y'all, because this next chapter is 30 minutes long. So y'all going to get this chapter. And child, that is going to be it. I don't know about that, boo-boo. Some lady said, I'm so happy I found your channel. Child, listen, I don't know. We'll see later. I tell folks, I'm an acquired taste, honey. Like Brussels sprouts and big dick. You know what I'm saying? You got to get used to that shit. Ooh, folks be thinking they ready for that shit till they get it. Everybody want a big dick till it's a big ass dick in their face. Then everybody crossing their legs and talk about, no, I can feel my uterus thumping. Shit, that looks scary. No, don't be scared now. You was begging for it. Shit. Mm-mm. Nope. Nope, nope, nope. She said, wait a minute, I was busy. She said, what about level one? Girl, I done seen people cry at level one. Yep, because they not used to it. Everybody can't take it. And then other folks beg for it, even when they shouldn't be begging for it, because, yeah, it sometimes it get that deep. All right, so let me... while we wait for this one more thing here to go. I just did it again. God damn it, Saki. What the fuck? All right. I'm trying to read these little things. So y'all get ready for this. This is going to be the last chapter. She talking about not user friendly, huh? You stay around long enough, Buns, and you finna get B2, right? Listen, Buns almost got jacked up the other night. She just don't realize it. I was in a real good mood, so I was like, all right. But I don't forget a goddamn thing. I just make a mental note. But eventually, that's my way of saying eventually. Eventually, she'll fuck up too. Talking about child, I done laughed tonight. Child, listen. Nope, you ain't innocent, baby. No, ma'am. And sometimes, but not in the way that you might think, honey. I like them. Oh my God. Y'all see how women come over to the speakeasy and cut up, be flashing folks like it's Mardi Gras and shit. I like big dinglings, girl. She said, I'm willing to try. Oh my God. Listen, the girl, you. Child, it depends on where you at. We have to have a conversation because, child, I could hook you up with somebody who can help you try. Ooh, good Lord. Mm-mm. Women be asking for shit. Like gym memberships and then don't fucking use them. Go one damn time and be like, that ain't for me. Ma'am, you paid for the year. Fuck is you talking about? You better go. Well, I do stay out my business, Peanut. Oh my God, listen. Oh my God, y'all so silly. She tell me I ain't even do shit. Not tonight, but you did the other night. You don't even remember. You was just having yourself a good time. Mm-hmm. I ain't called your ass crazy. Other folks did, but I didn't. I just peep game. I recognize. I see every fucking thing. She talking about, y'all remember that song, Hurt Man. Oh, wifey. Let me find out, girl. Girl, listen, Linda. All right, let me quit fucking playing and get y'all this last damn chapter, because I was trying to wait to the 30-minute mark, because right at that moment, I'm going to start. All right. Girl, this shit is still fucking stuck. I'm so fucking annoyed. I still say 8:29. Bruh, come on. How long does a fucking minute take to pass? That's the longest fucking minute. That just made me think of something. Ooh, child. What Monique said, she told that nigga, take it out, nigga, my eyebrows is burning. That's the longest goddamn minute ever. Oh, Lord Jesus. That's how I know you ain't ready, Jay. You ain't ready. Hey, Jazzy. Welcome, boo. Thank you for being here. I appreciate you. Oh, Lord have mercy. I don't know, girl. You must not have your notifications on all, because, yeah. So Buck said, see, them the ones you got to block if it ain't serious. They'll come looking for your ass in the daylight with a flashlight. Child, listen. No, Monique said it make her eyebrows burn, child. That's what she said. That's what she said. So I don't know. I have to take her word for it, honey. Because I don't know what be going on with that lady body. She said it made her eyebrows burn. I'm going to just stop right there, because that ain't none of my goddamn business. I really don't want to know. All right, let's get ready for this last chapter. It's the countdown coming. Okay. We almost at the moment. Oh, shit. Saki, you didn't. Child, listen. Ain't this about a bibbity bobbity bitch? Lord have mercy. All right, y'all. Here we go. It's counting down. Y'all a mess. She said it does. I'm just saying. Lord have mercy. Okay, child. All right. Chapter 15, Christina. Rehab was actually more than I expected it to be once I started taking the program seriously. I participated in groups more and even started talking to some of the girls that were there. The girl I'd gotten the closest to was the person who had the private room next to me. She was kind of cool. I'd been learning to work the steps and learned some coping methods. I'd been talking to Ember 2 or 3 times a day, and I'd learned to trust her. Girl, fuck you, because you full of shit. Dust bucket back, bitch. Nigga done paid for your shit, and you tell me, I don't want to talk to you no more, hussy. Over the last couple of weeks, she'd learned everything there was to know about me, and we were working through each issue step by step, using the steps and finding coping mechanisms. With the AD Enterprises NDA, I was able to tell her the most gruesome things that I'd gone through with crime and how Amos protected me. Pause. He should have said, oh, since the bitch took me off the list, give me my fucking NDA. Let me revamp the shit. You can't talk about what the fuck she told you about me, but anything that raggedy bitch tell you about her, you got free reign with that shit. Child. Some of these dudes like drama, so I'm gonna keep reading. Even though she never admitted, she showed me a little favoritism. don't like this girl no more. It was a little after six and I was getting ready for one of the last big things I had to do before I got my certificate of completion. And that was a meeting with my parents. That issue had me and Ember about to go round for round in her little office. It took me a long ass time to start seeing shit from a different perspective because I wasn't having it. After Ember and I finally came to a mutual understanding, we were able to set a meeting between all of us, and I was really looking forward to it. I hadn't talked to or seen my mom since I'd left the hospital. Learning, and it says learning. I'm looking with my good eye. It says learning closer into the mirror. I rubbed my moisturizer in. Another thing I'd been doing in here was just focusing on my mind and body. I'd slowed down on the snacks that Stephen brought and started eating a very high-protein diet with a lot of vegetables while drinking nothing but water. Pause. Stephen, you ain't got to go to the rehab no more. That bitch ain't talking to me no more and took me off the list. I don't give a fuck if she snack on the dead flies in the windowsill and the dead roaches in the corner. Fuck the hoe. Right. And by the way, if I'm paying for this shit, I ain't paying for it no more. Fuck her. Let her go dig crime's ass up and see if he'll fucking pay for it. Funky back heifer. Anyway, eating better along with yoga 5 times a week and the treadmill had my body looking the best that it looked in a long ass time. The healthy weight I'd picked up distributed perfectly. This was the most beautiful I'd felt in years. Yeah, thanks to him. Fucking bitch. I almost said something really bad, and I don't want to do that. My skin was very clear, and my hair was growing out. This morning, I cried because of how good I looked and felt. I just finished putting on some of my lip gloss when I heard a knock on the door. Hi, coming in. It was a tech. Ember is waiting for you. Your parents are here. Okay, thank you. I just have to put on my shoes. Even though the weather was chilly, I chose to just wear socks with a pair of slides. What? I wasn't going to be outside long, so the long sleeve shirt and sweatpants were enough. She held the door open for me as I walked outside. I hugged myself when the wind hit me in my face. The tech walked me to Ember's office and let me in. She was sitting behind her desk with her phone pressed to her ear. She ended the call just as I plopped down on the couch. Give me a few minutes and you can bring her parents back, Ember said to her. The girl nodded her head before closing the door. How are you feeling? You look good. I feel good. Honestly, I didn't think that we'd get a breakthrough regarding these people, but here we are. I'm actually grateful for the extra time. Good. I knew you would. Are you going to be open-minded and hear everything out of both of their mouths before you react? I nodded my head. I told you. I'm okay now. I did my yoga twice today and worked out for this moment. I'm in a state of zen now. Today, I begin a new life, for I am the master of my abilities, and today is going to be a great and beautiful day, I said, copying that quote from Baby Boy. Then she started laughing. She cleared her throat when the tech knocked on the door. You are so silly, girl. Come in. The door opened and my parents walked in. They looked great. My mother had truly settled into housewife life. They looked like they'd just come from a Christmas party with matching sweaters and black pants. Hey, my baby, my mom spoke. I stood and my mom pulled me into a bear hug. Oh my God, you look so cute. I like that you're letting your hair grow back. She released me and looked me in my face before kissing the top of my head and smelling my hair. Your hair smells really good. I pulled away from her and gave my dad a side hug before sitting cross-legged on the couch. Ember walked around her desk and shook both of their hands before offering them a seat. They sat across from me in the chairs and Ember sat at the head of the circle. So it's nice to finally meet the people that I've heard so much about and to put your faces with your names. I'm Ember, her therapist here. I'm so glad that you two could make it. They looked at her while I was looking at them. So let's get started. Christina, would you like to start us off? Man, fuck you. This that bullshit, yo. I promise you this is that bullshit. I don't like that more than likely her mama is probably going to bring old boy up during the therapy session. And, ugh, I don't know, y'all. I'm annoyed by it. Give me 1 second. Sorry, I had to let a couple people into the dig over there. All right. I inhaled and exhaled slowly before focusing on my dad. Dad, I have to apologize to you because I could have been a better kid, but you, Christina, I statements only. A tight smile spread across my face. I could have been a better kid, and I didn't have to make your life as hard as I did before I completely moved out. I was very hurt and started channeling that anger into using drugs and completely turning on you instead of just talking to you about my feelings. I know that both you and Mom love me, and nothing that you all did had anything to do with me, but I paused. But I didn't appreciate being left out of this for as long as it was kept from me. Although I have no influence on your decisions, I wish I wasn't left out in the cold for so long. I nodded my head when I was done. I was proud of myself because I'd come a long way. The first apology I'd written down was telling them to go fuck themselves and be a family without me. Anything you want to say to your mother, honestly? I looked at Ember with a tight smile and then at my mom. I hadn't really practiced what I was going to say to my mother because nothing I wanted to say to her was going to come out in a good way. Just say it, my mom said. Shh, Ember quietly shushed her. I just feel like you are a bit hypocritical in what and who you've taught me to be. I looked at Ember. That came out good, right? She nodded her head quickly. Keep going. I looked at my mom. You've always taught me about intuition and to always follow it and all that stuff, but you ended up back with the same man that was the reason you were in prison. I know what you told me about you being mad and whatnot, and y'all were seeing the therapist and the stuff, but I just didn't think there was that much therapy in the world for you to forgive him for that. And I know you told him to have the kids with her, but it is strange to me. I don't think I'll ever be able to connect with them. Seeing them, I'll be seeing her, and it'll be taking me back to that day I saw you deranged. I shrugged my shoulders. You do know. Say anything, Christina. Wait, you do know. Say anything. Or no, say everything. That's what she meant. Say everything, Christina. I mean, that was it. I think she's weak, and that's not who she raised me to be. My mom nodded her head slowly as tears welled up in her eyes. There are things that you don't know. My dad grabbed her hand and kissed the back of it. I cheated on your father. I looked taken aback. I didn't know he knew. When I was sentenced and he got better enough to visit, I'd turned him away many times until he wrote me detailing that he knew about me having sex with one of his old military buddies. While he was gone. Ironically, he'd walked in on us, but quietly left. Came back days later as if he'd just gotten home. He figured that he deserved it because he hadn't been being a very good husband. It's why he took us on that trip to Arizona and started trying to be better. I guess he figured that since he forgave me for cheating, I could at least hear him out. A lump grew in my throat as my mom grabbed a tissue from the box that Ember had sat on the table. I couldn't believe what I was hearing. If you asked me about my parents' relationship when I was younger, I would have told you that outside of regular arguments, my parents were perfect. That Arizona trip was so fucking long before my mother caught him cheating and snapped, and I honestly couldn't remember if my dad changed around that time or not. Oh, my God. Chrissy, I don't want you to think that I tried to guilt your mother into forgiving me. I just wanted her to know that I knew about her indiscretions as well. I made it clear that I was so damn sorry for ever doing that to her. Sleeping with Maya wasn't in retaliation for what your mother did. It was just a moment of weakness that I had. I love your mother, and I never stopped. I wish I could take back what I did. I never stopped loving you either. It just felt like the more I pushed, the more you pulled away from me. So I stopped so you wouldn't cut me completely off, but you ended up doing that anyway. I didn't replace you with my other kids, Chris, and you know that. I accept your apology too. Man, nigga, fuck you. How the fuck was she supposed to know that? If it felt to her, motherfucker, like you replaced her with your other kids, then bitch, nigga, that's what she felt. Because that's what she did. Whether you want to admit it or not, parents hate when kids lay their fucking dirty ass, shitty ass drawers on the table for them to have a look at their own fucking shit tracks before arguing or condemning their own children for the shit tracks in their drawers. Lousy bastards. Listen,
Anyway, let me get back to it because I'm on a clock here. Woo! Well, do you have any expectations for your parents once you're out of rehab, Christina? Yes, a few. Do not try to thrust your children, my siblings, onto me. Let it happen naturally. Don't expect us to be buddy-buddy. I honestly think that's it for me. Mr. and Mrs. Chase, we can only do as much as she lets us, so we can do that, so I can do that. Now, how will we know that you're making an effort if you don't want us to put you all into the room together? My dad asked. Maybe I'll ask to come over for dinner or something. Who knows? Well, we are invited to spend Christmas with the Dukes and, oh God, and on Thanksgiving, they were with their mom, so they'll be there. I won't show up then. That's literally in a few days, and that's too soon. Christina, if you don't show up, you'll be alone, and I don't want you to be alone on Christmas. It's your favorite holiday. Mom, I was alone on Thanksgiving. I'll manage. Plus, I don't want to be there anyway, and I haven't bought anyone any gifts. Oh, okay, wait a minute. She's trying to write in a dialect. Now I get it. This is not about that boy, is it? My dad asked. No, that's over. My mom squinted at me. I'm serious. I haven't spoken to him. And besides, even if I wanted to be with him, do you think he would want to be with me after you accused him of feeling guilty and not really loving me? And after you nearly took a knife to his mom? Val told me about the dinner and how she cut up really bad. If I had been there, I would have been so embarrassed and would have left the house in shame. I just wanted to protect you. Thank you. I appreciate it, Mom. She stared at me. Don't look like that. It was genuine. Are you getting back with him? She looked at Ember. Tell her that she can't get back with him and that he doesn't love her the way that she loved him. Mrs. Chase, we've always discussed that. Just as I've told her that she can't make decisions for you two, you can't make decisions for her. And we won't. But can you promise that you'll come to us if you need us? My dad said. I promise, really. I must admit that I am a better person because of Ember and this place. I'm clear-headed and focused. I'll do my part. If I feel that my peace is about to get disrupted, I'll leave the situation. We all smiled at each other. I didn't think it would be that easy to have that difficult conversation, but it needed to be had. I would have never known that my mother cheated on my father and cheated first. She's a whore. What did you expect? I'm sorry. I'm just playing. That's not in the book. And I don't really think that lady's a whore. I think she's a bitch, but not a whore. Over the next hour, we chatted about her life and how she was thinking about trying to get a job as an assistant somewhere, which was surprising, even though my father said that she didn't have to work. Well, she need to do something so her ass don't run around and fuck another motherfucker. I couldn't lie and say that I wasn't having a good time catching up with them and seeing them interact with each other. With a clear head, I could see that they were still in love with each other. And I was a fool to try and get in the way of that. Right, because who in the fuck in their right mind jumps in the middle of two ghetto-ass fools who happen to be in love? Not me. I mind my goddamn business. When it was time for them to leave, I was actually a little sad to see them go. Man, fuck this girl. You people asked me to read this book. I told y'all this was some bullshit. It's a break in the chapter. And still 18 minutes left. I think that's what it say out of my blurry eye. Yeah, it's 18 minutes, y'all. Lord have mercy. This is some bullshit. That night, it was a little after midnight and I couldn't sleep for shit. Every time I closed my eyes, I thought about him. You know what? Why does that make me feel like when Bernie Mac was like... that little girl talking about him downstairs. Like, you know, with the snooty attitude. That's how I feel like this girl got it. She's an ungrateful hussy, but whatever. But this time apart was needed and necessary for us. At least I thought so. Honestly, I thought that by now he'd be seen out with different women to further my spiral, but it wasn't anything like that. Even though I told Ember that I didn't want him to have any more updates on me, that didn't stop me from checking up on him. Dusty bitch. Confused ass. During the hour or two we had on the computer, I'd be typing his name into Google just to see what he'd been doing. Each picture of him in his tailored suits made me hornier than the last. When I saw the picture of him on the beach with his shirt off and short swim trunks. I had to exit out because I fucking knew what was between his legs. I knew what those little ass shorts were holding hostage between his legs, and I nearly had an orgasm in the seat. I hope he'll never give it to your funky ass no more. Another part of me focusing on myself was not thinking about or sex. Wait, not thinking about or sex or even playing with my pussy. That's what it says. I was taking this detox as serious as I possibly could, but tonight I couldn't take my mind off him for anything in the world. I couldn't stop thinking about the last time we were together before he left and went to New York. He fucked me every way that he could. Fast, slow, hard, soft. It was almost like he knew he wouldn't be fucking me for a long time or something. Each stroke was perfect. There was something about him and headboards that made him get deep in his sex bag. He turned me over on my stomach, straddled my thighs, and thrust it inside of me. His length and girth weren't shit to play with. When I closed my eyes, I saw that exact position. Why your pussy so motherfucking good, girl? He pulled out of me and pushed inside of me again. Christina, shit, girl, he whispered. I pulled one of the pillows from behind my head and put it between my legs, squeezing it tight. I hadn't nutted in what felt like years. He gripped the top of the headboard and dug deeper inside of me. Baby, you are so, so, so deep. That's where you want me, right? My knees were nearly touching because of how tight I clenched the pillow. Turning on my side, I pulled my other pillow from under my head and clutched it in front of me, resting my face in the pillow, trying to keep it together. Spread them cheeks for me, Ma. I did what I was told, reaching behind me and spreading my cheeks. Pussy so fucking pretty, bae, he whispered, pushing deeper into me. He had to have pushed another inch in me. Oh, my God, eh? Shit, baby. Keep that ass open. I started rocking against the pillow. Between the friction from my panties and the pressure of the pillow, I was about to explode. The pressure building in my lower stomach could make me scream out bloody murder. You love me, Chris? Yes. Fuck yes. I love you, Amos. Arching my back, I pushed my ass up into him. Oh, fuck, Chris. Don't do that, baby. That's gonna make me come. I arched deeper. Hey, I'd grown hotter. My pussy was swollen and soaked. Good fucking girl, coming on my dick like that. Creamy as fuck. I was too spent to keep my ass up in the air. Nah, put that ass up and spread that ass open for me. With the little energy I had left, I arched my back and spread my cheeks. You wet as fuck. He gripped the headboard with both hands and started pounding my pussy. Yes. Fuck. Yes, baby. Push that pretty ass up against me. What the fuck? That was the wrong voice, but whatever. You got it. Anyway, I laid there and took that thrashing like the bad bitch I was. Oh, my God. I'm not reading that. Anyway, he thrust in me one last time before falling on my damn back. God damn, girl, he whispered in my ear while his dick jumped inside of me. Oh, that's always so nice. Anyway, I laid on my back staring at the ceiling. It was spinning. I could barely catch my fucking breath. It took nearly 10 minutes for my heart rate to go back to normal. Climbing out of bed, I walked over to the sink, put some cold water on a towel, and dabbed my face and neck. I was wearing just a pair of panties and bralette, showing off both tattoos and he loved so much. I didn't regret them at all. That man and his dick had a hold on me, and I wasn't afraid to admit it. Honestly, I knew that once he was informed that he couldn't get any more updates on me or send me messages, he was going to move on. But he didn't. That madman tried to bribe people at the job to get a message to me. This was an all-women's rehab facility, including the staff, which meant that there were going to be a few that were catty, and it got back to me. Well, I overheard it. A few nights while I was up painting, I'd seen that red dot flashing in the window. He was relentless, and somehow that turned me on even more. When he showed up here in the middle of my yoga class, he looked different. The stubble on his face made him even more handsome. Because I wasn't expecting him and didn't want him to see me that way, I moved out of the way of the door. Seeing him looking desperate made me want to jump on him. It was then that I knew I had a hold on him, too.
Ember told me that we'd eventually have to sit down and get our real feelings out there to clarify where we stood, but I wasn't strong enough for that yet. Before he could get two words out of his mouth, I'd have his dick in my mouth. Child, listen. And she didn't like that very much, but it was the truth. This celibacy thing wasn't for me. It helped clear my head, but it was not for me. After getting cleaned up, I sat down at my easel. I'd been working on this current piece since Thanksgiving night, and it still wasn't done. No matter what kind of art I do for the rest of my life, this would be the most important piece. It was my own version of the laugh now, cry later artwork. Instead of doing two faces, I did three. It was young, wild, and free Chris with all the hair, and then there was the spiraling young adult bald head Chris, and the third face was me now. I called it the EOC, Evolution of Chris. Whatever, bitch. When I put the paint to it, it was going to be so beautiful. And it's another fucking break in this long-ass chapter.
I'm annoyed.
Okay. Y'all give me 1 second. Thank you. All right, sorry. All right. The next day, I woke up feeling on top of the world. I think that orgasm was what I needed last night. It even gave me the energy to work on my painting until the sun came up. I'd probably crash after my first group therapy session. I just walked into the building, heading to breakfast. I stomped a little bit of water and mud off my boots. Walking further into the building, it was unusually quiet. As soon as I turned on the hallway, three techs were rushing toward me. Christina, Ember needs to see you right now, one of the techs said. Why? It's early as hell. It's urgent, the tech said in the middle. Sheesh, okay. Damn. Oh my God, he dead? That mean he dead, a girl shouted from the TV room. Being nosy, I tried to walk by them to go to the TV room, but they blocked me. Nuh-uh, y'all doing too much, I told them. Dipping under their arms, I rushed into the TV room. They all turned and looked at me at the same time. The TV was on CNN, showing a split screen with a video of Amos on one side getting his picture snapped on a red carpet, and the other side in a video of his black car smashed into trees and a large white sheet over the driver's side of the car. My hand went to my mouth. Car registered to Amos Duke involved in deadly car accident is what the caption said on the screen. Christina, one of the techs called my name, trying to pull me away from the TV room, but I was stuck. Dang, I'm sorry, Christina, one of the girls said. Christina, come on! Two techs grabbed each of my arms and another tech pushed me in my back and away from the TV room. Ciao. My knees went weak and they ended up having to carry me. Y'all didn't miss nothing. I had to fucking press the mute button to say what I felt. Reports are coming. Sadly, it was Amos Duke was the last thing I heard before I passed out. When I came to, I sat up in a panic on Ember's couch in her office. I pulled the cool towels off my neck and head. Ember sat behind her desk with her phone to her ear. I gotta get out of here. Ember shot up and rushed across the room, grabbing me. She was strong as hell. I gotta get out of here, I screamed at the top of my lungs. Christina, please calm down. Please. I can't. I need to call Irvy. Call Irvy. I've called every number and I'm not getting anyone. Calm down. What I tell you, focus on what you can control right now. Breathe. I'm calling everyone back to back until I get in touch with them. Sit down, please. What the fuck do she care? What does she care? Because guess what? You broke up with him, remember? You said you ain't want to talk to him. Hey, nigga, where's my shit? I'm sorry, my son. What did you do with it? Oh, you was trying to charge it for me? Okay, thank you. No, go ahead if you're charging it. Oh, okay. Why are you trying to be such a good son?
Why you can't suck like everybody else's son suck? Because it sort of try to kind of make me feel bad for hollering at you all the time, but fuck that.
Shit. I'm sorry to those of y'all that are here for the book. All right, I just upped the bucks to 5. It's cool though. Yep, I did. Forgive me. I'm sorry. All right. Tears streamed down my face. I just lost my... He's a duke. He's so careful. No, that's not... I muttered. Right, see, she was muttering. I know how to read. Shit. Ember led me over to the couch and sat me down. I gotta leave. I gotta go find Val. When I get in contact with them, I'll have them come right away. I'm getting your discharge papers ready right now. Okay, thank you, Ember. You're more than welcome. I'm here. I'm not going anywhere. True to her word, she called every number back to back for over an hour before I finally sobbed myself to sleep. My body reacted to the sudden warmness I felt over my arms and neck. My nose didn't miss the light, subtle cologne smell from the jacket. When I felt the dip on the couch, I opened my eyes slowly. My face was so tight from crying that it nearly hurt to keep my eyes open. Turning my head slightly, I gasped when I noticed who'd sat on the couch. Amos! I sat up so fast, clutching my heart. My heart was beating so fast that I had to cough a few times to catch my breath. You making trouble again? I blinked twice to make sure I didn't see any wings or a shadow behind him. This bitch is dumb. Not wings or a shadow. Lord have mercy. Amos, I breathed. Yes, baby, it's me. You're not dreaming. You can't kill a duke. Come on now. I jumped in his lap. I bet you did. Wrapping my arms around him as I started to sob into his neck. He wrapped his arms around me, kissing my shoulder. Baby, don't cry. Stop crying before you have a heart attack or something now. I love you, Amos. I love you so much. I know, baby. I know. I love you too. Stop crying. He rubbed his hands up and down my back slowly until I calmed down. The news. They said you were... Yeah. Motherfuckers just be interested in being first instead of correct. One of my car service guys' workers was driving the car and his body tensed up. Baby, we don't have to talk about that right now. Nah, I'ma get pissed thinking about it. I raised up and looked in his eyes. Please, tell me. Just problems from beyond the grave, that's all. He pinched my cheek. Don't worry about that in here. What grave, eh? Baby, tell me. I deserve to know. No, fuck no, you don't deserve to know, bitch. Remember, he ain't on the list no more. You don't want to talk to him. You ain't going to crim or dinner. Why you want to know his business? This is where bitches get it fucked up at. That's what I'm talking about. He sighed. Well, my service guy was shot before he crashed into the tree. The only person who would want to shoot at my car is niggas trying to get some street justice for crime. I sat back a little, pressing my fingers against my lips. He nodded his head. I wrapped my arms around him again. How many times are you going to save me, Amos? As many times as I have to, Chris. He pushed me back a little so he could look in my eyes. Baby, I'll do it over and over and over again. No matter how many times, if you need me, I'm here. He cupped my face with his large hand and touched the rims of my eyes. Your eyes are so puffy. You really thought you lost me. I nodded my head. Even though you cut me off? You don't just cut feelings off like that. I wish I could, so I wouldn't have been going crazy since I cut you off. But it was for the best. For me, anyway. I've been laser focused. I actually feel so much better. You look better. Picking up weight. He squeezed my ass and thighs. Looking good as hell. You growing your hair out and shit? Man, Ember said I didn't have long because what? Why you looking down and blushing? She told you that I wasn't ready to see you because I'd have your dick in my mouth. He cocked his head to the side with a huge smirk on his face. That's what you said? Oh, God. I am so embarrassed. What did she say? All she said was that I can't stay long because you weren't strong enough to see me yet, but I would like to talk more about my dick being in your mouth, though. what you embarrassed for? We've exchanged saliva and lots of bodily fluids before. You have nothing to be embarrassed about.
I know, it's just...
Amos, I bit the corner of my lip. Talk to me, Chris.
It's weird that last night I'd come to the conclusion that I was in love with you. I hadn't been able to get you off my mind, even though I'd cut you off. I kept trying to tell myself that you didn't feel the same, and with me being out of sight and out of mind, you'd move on. And I have to admit, I'd been Googling your name, praying that I'd see you with another woman so I could confirm my suspicions and I could get most of my grieving out in here. But when I hadn't seen you with another woman, and then you showed up here, looking how I felt on the inside, Amos, that's when I knew. I knew that I was in this shit deep with you. I knew that you were in this deep with me. I wanted to blame you for the baby. I wanted to drill in my head that you didn't even like me for real. You unlocked a part of me that I wanted to keep locked. Vulnerability. I wanted to keep that part of me locked so I could never experience the hurt and pain I felt with crime again. As mean as you were to me, once I was stuck in your house, I saw right through your ass. He tried to hide the fact that his eyes watered by closing his eyes and gripping the bridge of his nose like I wasn't looking dead in his face. Damn. I mean, of course, we have so much to talk about before we start defining what's going on between us, but I think as long as we start being 100% real with each other, we can make it work with each other, but only if you want to, though. No pressure. That made him throw his head back and laugh. You want to be like me. When did you start saying no pressure? Freaking Ember. Would she be asking me questions and shit? So, you doing really well in here, I take it. Yes. When you told me that I'd be thanking you later, I never thought it would be so soon, but thank you. I'm going to get you a gift when I get out of here to show my appreciation. Can I have a kiss right now? Like a pre-gift, if you will? It's been hard on here for a pimp. It's hard out here for a pimp. My bad. What the fuck am I reading? I'm sorry. A bitch got one good eye, and that motherfucker ain't but about 60% his fucking self. But I don't need no glasses, though. Fuck out of here. All right. It's been hard out here for a pimp. Not Mr. I have self-control. What happened? I licked my lips. Girl, he whispered, don't do that. It's been a long time, and I do have self-control. I haven't fucked anybody else. I can still miss your good-ass pussy. He adjusted himself under me so I could feel his hard-ass dick. I knew it had to hurt in those tight-ass tailored pants he wore every day. Two buttons were unbuttoned, showing off a small chain. He was still letting the hair on his face grow, but he'd gotten his hair cut into his normal low cut. He was turning into his brother right before my eyes, and he looked fucking sexy while doing it. What's on your mind, baby? You giving me that look. The way I'm feeling, I'll put you through this couch, girl. My pussy automatically kegels just thinking about last night. I'd been orgasm depraved until last night. His eyebrows went together. What that mean? Please don't say anything crazy. Not right now. I put a pillow between my legs and thought about the last time we were together when you were telling me to hold my ass open. I was so fucking wet. I could have squirted myself through the wall from the pressure that was built up inside of me. He laughed. And then he laughed some more. Damn, I missed your ass, man. Well, that makes me happy. Can I have a kiss though, Chris? Wetting my lips, I leaned forward, pressing my lips against his. I pushed my tongue in his mouth, and he started sucking on it, making me moan in his mouth. My body heated up as he pulled my lips into his mouth and sucked on them. I would have never known I loved this type of freaky shit if it wasn't for him. My pussy started leaking. I had to pull away from him because I was about to nut just from the kiss. The jean material wasn't helping, rubbing against my swollen clit. Why you pull away? I wasn't done. He grabbed the back of my neck and pulled me to him. I love you, Chris, he whispered against my lips. You don't gotta worry about shit from me. He pushed his tongue back into my mouth and I happily sucked on it. Dragging his hands down my back, he gripped my ass, pulling me to him. My dick is so fucking hard, girl. Damn. Reaching between us, I started fumbling with his belt, but he grabbed my hands. No, baby, not right here. I need you in my bed because I need hours. Days with you. When you get out, I'm gonna keep you locked in my fucking room for at least 3 days. Eat, sleep, fuck. I know that's right, Amos, but not with her. Pick another bitch. I'm sick of this hoe. He had my bottom lip clamped in his teeth when Ember came back in the room. She immediately put her hands up to her eyes. Oh, God, please tell me he's not naked under you. I just got that couch. That made both of us laugh. He's not naked, Ember. Okay, good. I climbed off him and handed him his jacket. He folded it and laid it across his lap. Yes, hide that fucking log. Shit. Okay, Amos, I'm glad that you were able to come, but I'm about to start my therapy classes in a few and I need you to go. Damn, you sure she treating you right? Because she treats me like shit, he said. She raised her eyebrows in response. My apologies, I didn't mean to make you feel like shit, but I respect my client's wishes. Good, I can respect that. When he stood up, he folded his jacket over his arm to cover his crotch area. He pulled me to my feet and pulled me into a hug with his free hand. He smells so damn good. What are you about to go do? This pomp and circumstance with the police so I can look at the traffic cameras to see if I can see the exact face of the motherfucker that thought he could pull up on me. I'm annoyed because I have to pay for this boy's funeral when he was the one trying to stunt in my damn car. The fucking car was bulletproof. Why he fucking riding with the windows down anyway? Fuck. Anyway, can't do anything else about it now. Fucking up my Christmas spirit. That made me laugh, even though he was serious as hell. All right, baby. You see me. I'm good. Don't be in here passing out no more. I can't wait to see you. I'll be the one with the ugly Christmas sweater on. What? I laughed. AD Enterprises has Christmas parties? We only have hundreds of employees who work their asses off for us, so we gotta show them we appreciate them some way. Aw, that's sweet. I hugged him again. I know. I love you. He kissed my forehead and then both my cheeks before pecking my lips. I love you too. He nodded his head at Ember before walking out of the room. My cheeks burned and I couldn't wait to see what Ember had to say. This funky ass bitch. Who care what she gotta say? Because I don't even like it. The fuck? Anyway, well, that was something. It really was. I wish we could talk more, but I have a patient coming. All right, I'll see you later. I left her office on cloud 9. And that's the end of that chapter. Child, listen, I'm sick of this bullshit. The fuck? All right. Let me see. I thought I saw somebody come in. Hey, Nah, welcome. Was it Nay or Nah? I don't know. Miss Nay, I think. Hey, Saki. Hey, everyone. My first time catching a live. Just wanted to say hi. I'm currently listening to Property of a Rich Nigga. Ah, okay. Well, welcome. Thank you for being here. I appreciate you. All right. Look at this heifer here. Put me through the couch. Wait, what Buck say? I be trying to chill, but she keep giving me ammo, wifey. Yeah, I. She tell my damn Buck, you up there with me? No, ma'am, you at 10. He at 5. Uh-huh. Well, that's all right. Mm-hmm. I'm trying to see what else. Did I miss anybody else that came in? Because I want to make sure before I get the fuck up out of here, because I'm about to go, child. All right, y'all, this was fun. I really had a good time with y'all. I always do. And those of you that were put on lists tonight, yeah, just get ready, baby, because this is happening. So you just got to relax and let it happen because it's happening. So anyway, I appreciate y'all for being here. I really do. I had a good time. You know, I always do with y'all. So now don't run, pimping. Don't run. Oh, man. So anyway, I ain't got to thank Love Jones tonight, but I'm going to. You know, she working hard and she my little sister. So, you know. When you got a good little sister, child, you just try to keep them, okay? So even though she wasn't here, this is for all the time she was but couldn't talk. So, yeah, it's all right. I saw Deborah come in here, honey. She corrected my pronunciation of her name. It's not Deborah, bitch. It's Deborah. Okay. I'm sorry, honey.
I hope I said it right, child, because I don't want to get beat the fuck up in my own shit. I mean, that ain't going to happen, but I'm just saying, you know, I just want to make sure. She's saying it's Deborah. Deborah, not Deborah. I guess, child. I want to make sure I say it right, honey, because I hate when people be like, hey, Saki. People say that shit all the time. Soon as I drop in the chat, hey, Saki. How the fuck you get Saki out of that? There's no C there. The C is what elongates the A like that. My name is Saki. Like, suck you in your fucking face, right? Not Saki. Fucking Saki, man. Like, you niggas ain't never been to a Japanese restaurant and had a little bit of Saki. I know on that Saki, there's an E at the end. People still fuck that up. Right, but anyway, my whole thing, I always say it's pronounced the same as the rice wine. God damn, people, do you not fucking get it? But they still say Saki, so I just ignore their asses and keep it pushing. Anyway, so yes, I had a good time. I don't like to butcher anybody's name, so yeah. Child, listen. They be saying Saki. I don't know how. I don't know. Anyway, this day has been a whole trip, so I'm cool on it. I can only see out of one eye real good. The other eye blurry as a bitch. So that must be the universe telling me to take my punk ass to bed a little early tonight, because I hate it when I can't fucking see. All right, y'all. I love y'all. Y'all already know that. So y'all go forth and be safe and be great as you can. And, Buns, you on the list, child. Don't even worry about it, honey. You on the list. I just decided, you know, that fuck it. I was going to put you on the list because, you know, the shit you did the other day and, you know, how you really thought you was in the clear today. You know, nah, you on the list, child. Mm-mm. So it's just that simple. You'll be all right. Okay. Y'all have a good night. Please be safe out there. And if you do nothing else, please salute your spirit and protect your peace. Oh, you was here. It was the same night that Deborah corrected me on the pronunciation of her name. She dropped in and said, oh, Saki, I know Buns in real life. Yeah, she is crazy. That's what she said. Go back and look at the motherfucking video. Make sure you have the chat set to all messages. Because some of y'all be having it just say top chat up there. You got to hit the button so that it say all messages. Oh, yeah, baby girl. Your friend is the one who said she is crazy. That part. Yes. Whatever night that was, that's the night you nut the fuck up. And I was hovering my hand over the list. But little do you know, being put on that list ain't all that happened. But it's all good, child. Listen, she said, I remember that, but I didn't do shit tonight. Yeah, but thinking that you were so cool, you was in the clear, is what made you think. That's what made you think that you wasn't on the list, but you was. I said it. You was on the list. You just missed it. You just didn't hear me. I said it. Oh, yeah. Yeah. I'm waiting to see if your homie want to get on the list with you too. It's okay. It's plenty of room on the list, child. It's plenty of room on the list. Anybody that want to be on the list, yeah, they could be on there. Right, thought you wasn't, but you was. You so fucking silly. Right, she talking about, wow, that's crazy. Actually, it's not. But I promise you, it's all good. She said it's Deborah. Deborah, right? That's your name, right? I thought I said it right. Child, I don't know. I don't know what to say. She said, I'm different. Not like her crazy. See, here go your home girl again calling you crazy. You can't blame that on me, pimping. She came in here talking about, y'all call me crazy and everything. No, I didn't. Peanut, you already know. That's it. That's it. So, yeah. But that's it. I didn't call you crazy. Your homegirl did. And she just did it again. She just did it again. So yeah, that's all. And you wasn't, you know, on the list, but you was like, yep,
I ain't on that list.
She talking about see her bougie ass ain't shit. Y'all all crazy. Oh my God, today. All right, y'all, listen, let me get the fuck out of here because y'all crazy. I know one goddamn thing. You know you're not supposed to go out my front door. If you let any of them fucking scout mosquitoes up in here, you're going to have to pack your grip and take a trip, young man. The fuck? I'm sorry. Oh, my God. Because the scout mosquitoes be so bad. Oh, my God. I hate it. They be all big and scary looking. Ugh. Talking about niggas free diving on the list, okay? Now, y'all talking about, Lord, I done cost two friends. They ain't gonna be friends after this fucking. No, scout mosquitoes. Scout. S-C-O-U-T. Scout. Yeah, they come out to look for places for mosquitoes to be able to lay their eggs and, not their eggs, their larvae, sorry, so that they can be attacking the fuck out of you in the summertime, which is probably going to start tomorrow down here in this fucking schizophrenic ass weather. That's what Texas weather is, schizophrenic. All right, y'all. So let me get, oh yeah, no, not scalp, scout. He heard me. Right. Oh, Lord. All right, y'all. I'm going to get out of here. I love y'all. She said the list out here ruining friendships. Right. Buns and Deborah, child, are not going to be friends no more after tonight. So anyway. All right. I love y'all. Y'all have a good night. I've been trying to get out of here for goddamn it 10 minutes. All right. I'll see y'all later on tomorrow. All right. Y'all have a good night. Again, if you do nothing else, please salute your spirit and protect your peace. Until next time, bye, y'all. See, that's that bullshit right there. That's the reason why she made the goddamn list right there. Tell my good night, Saki. Mm-hmm. That's it. That's it right there. There you go. She talking about Father God, good night. Y'all gonna be friends or no? Because I ain't the one that called you crazy. All right, y'all. I'm out of here for real. Tell my, wait a minute. Saki, don't go. I had to wait till she left. Wait, what? No, wait, Saki do go? Oh, it do go. Okay, all right. She said, I had to wait till she left. Oh, Lord have mercy. Y'all a mess. Siri ain't want to say Saki. She talking about, oh, damn it. Look at Seti say, I'll see you all later. Church lady like, I ain't in none of this shit. None of it. Thank you for being here, church lady, and for being good, child. The rest of these folks, I don't know, they a little iffy. If some people going to be like, wait, what the fuck did I do? No, God, all of y'all is in trouble except for church lady. But wait, church lady got put on the list. Yep, you on there. Sorry, not sorry. So Buck said, on a real note, auntie, I didn't get a notification today either. I thought you wasn't coming on tonight. Then you went live. I don't know. You didn't get one at all today? That's fucked up. Oh, my God. That's crazy. Who else didn't get it? Like, I need to lodge another complaint or something. Like, seriously. Because I'd be like, let me get my motherfucking feedback. Because this is bullshit. My people not getting their fucking notifications. What's up with that? You didn't? Are y'all fucking serious or y'all just fucking with me? Like, let me know so I can Okay, you got one today, but on Tuesday you didn't. Oh, she said she got hers from Buns. Jesus. Like, I'm annoyed that this, like, I promise you, every time somebody tell me that, I send feedback to YouTube. I do, because, like, at this point, I'm annoyed because I can't even begin to tell y'all how many DMs I get with people saying, why am I not getting your notifications? And I'm literally walking them through how to make sure that they have all selected, and they do. The white button is lit up. And, yeah. And this is just fucked up. I don't like it. It's crazy. I'm about to go and do this shit again. So she said, I'm serious. I just kept checking. Fuck. All right. Let me get off of here, y'all, for real. I'm about to go so I can do this feedback thing to YouTube, because I keep on doing it. I'm so serious. That is fucking annoying. Oh, my God. All right. I love y'all for real. I'll talk to y'all later. Y'all have a good night. I'm not going to play the music again. I'm just going to go. I need to do this thing right now so that I can make sure I put this timestamp for where in the video people are saying they didn't get their fucking notifications. All right. I love y'all. See you tomorrow. Have a good night.